sideline.
Thanks so much, John. We're here with Coach Chuck Amato. And Coach, you played here, you were assistant coach here, and now you're head coach here. What did you tell this team before they came out on the field?
It's to come out and play their hearts out, play one down at a time, and play a physical game. Just play a physical game and don't leave anything on the field.
Coach, good luck to you today.
Thank you.
Back upstairs.
As we mentioned, a beautiful day, warm on the field, 79 degrees, low humidity, very little breeze, and the forecast for sunny skies, and there isn't a cloud overhead on this beautiful campus. Carl Torbush, 1-8 last year, heading into the meeting in Erickson Stadium in Charlotte. They've played the last 2 years in Charlotte. The rivalry returns to campus this year and is likely to remain on the campuses for the foreseeable future. And they beat NC State, closed with a win over Duke. He saved his job. Mike O'Kane wound up losing his as Wolfpack head coach. Phillip Rivers has arrived as a true freshman to help lead them to the 4-1 start. And O'Kane, to the chagrin of some Wolfpack backers, has joined forces with the Tar Heels. He said if you can't beat them, join them, which didn't sit well with some NC State folks. But what was he supposed to do? NC State told him to take a walk, and he had to go find a job.
Well, and he's been through four changes as a coach, was hired as an assistant coach, was hired as a head coach, was fired as a head coach, and rehired as an assistant, and he never had to leave the same house that he's been in for 14 years. Not a bad deal for Mike O'Kane.
That's rare in coaching. Leave one job, take another, and not have to move. NC State won the toss and deferred, so North Carolina elected to receive the opening kickoff. Austin Herbert, the true freshman, kicks it away to Michael Waddell and Kevin Knight. And a booming kickoff through the back of the end zone. Corey Bailey, the outstanding wide receiver for North Carolina, bothered by a hamstring injury. Suffered 2 weeks ago against Georgia Tech, and it's still undetermined how much we'll see him today, but ordinarily he might be back there running back kicks. Ronald Curry, the junior quarterback from Hampton, Virginia.
5 interceptions, 4 of those coming in the last 2 ball games against Marshall and Georgia Tech. He has improved in that department. In 98 and 99, he threw 17 interceptions and only 9 touchdowns, so he's getting a little better. Michael Kane working with him day in, day out.
These are 2 big play offenses, like to throw the ball deep. Each has had difficulty getting the run going of late. And right on cue, Brandon Russell stopped for no gain. Now the Chili's starting lineup, the offensive unit for North Carolina. It's an inexperienced offensive front with Marchetti, the former walk-on, Holland, Metz, Morford, and Wagstaff, the front 5. Russell, the true freshman tailback, with Anthony Saunders, a converted tailback. Trumpler, perhaps the best tight end in the nation. Allen and Bailey listed as the starting wideouts. You checked on Bailey's status before the game.
Corey Bailey, he pulled his hamstring on a 78-yard touchdown pass against Georgia Tech. Ronald Curry has to take a timeout, and he'll go a little bit today, but they're worried about hurting him for the rest of the season.
Still sensitive enough as North Carolina calls the timeout. I feel like he could blow out that hamstring, and it could be a much more costly injury down the road. So they're going to play it carefully with Bailey Day. The good news for North Carolina, that is a position at which they have considerable depth, wide out.
One of the only positions really on offense that they have. They have 2 true freshmen starting at tailback. They have Brandon Russell starting, backed up by another true freshman. But Corey Bailey, a hamstring's a weird injury. It starts to get better, but when you go out and you start to get fatigued, he could tear that thing and be out for the rest of the season. They have to be very careful with him today.
North Carolina 3-2 overall, 1-2 in conference. Opened with wins against Tulsa and Wake Forest, then got bombed at Florida State. Bounced back with a nice win here against Marshall. But had the most disappointing loss of the season, of the 2, to Georgia Tech, a game they felt they should have won here at home. And they hurt themselves with a lot of mistakes, including a couple in the punt game.
They had 1 drop snap by Blake Ferguson, the true freshman punter, that cost him a touchdown, and then a blocked punt that was returned for a touchdown.
Mal Jones in it wide out. Curry in trouble, manages to turn it into a gain. He's chased out near the 24-yard line by the middle linebacker, D'Antonio Burnett. The Chili's defensive unit for North Carolina State. Up front, Goodson, Fisher, Bryant, and Smith. The strength of the defense, the linebackers. LeVar Fisher is leading the ACC in tackles with Burnett and Lyons. In for the injured Clayton White. In the secondary, it's Williams, Wilson, Holt, and Washington. And this defense played a lot of snaps last week at Clemson as Clemson ran 95 offensive plays. A On third and six out of the shotgun. Perry to the far sideline, and it is incomplete. A little bit short of Bosley Allen, who tried to make the catch just off the top of the grass. J.J. Washington had the coverage. Allen was open, and the ball a little bit underthrown by Ronald Curry. And immediately the punt unit comes on, and it'll be John Lafferty to punt. It was Blake Ferguson who had a couple of problems in the punting chores against Georgia Tech. Dropped one snap and had another one blocked, although the coaches say the block wasn't his fault. Low snap, well handled by Lafferty, a high but short punt. And Corin Robinson makes the fair catch at the 45-yard line. A great field position for the Wolfpack when we come back after a 31-yard punt. NC State on offense for the first time. The Pack from its own 45. Rivers out slinging to his favorite target, Corin Robinson, quickly into Tar Heel territory at the 47-yard line. A hookup of 8 yards for Phillip Rivers, the true freshman from Athens, Alabama.
Second in the country behind a guy, I think his name's Drew Brees. Pretty good guy out of Purdue. 4 interceptions, 16 touchdowns. That's also second in the country behind John Welsh of Idaho in one less game.
Second and two, they go without a huddle. They go to a quick pass, and Eric Leek dropped it. That might be a lateral and a fumble. Now the officials say incomplete pass. They hesitated a moment. That was very close to a lateral. Leek had a problem with drops last week against Clemson, and he sprung a leak on this throw.
Wow, Sean, awfully close to a lateral. If that's not exactly parallel to the line of scrimmage, very close. But Leek is looking back into a very strong sun. That sun setting right behind our booth here, right in the eyes of Eric Leek.
Leek's a senior from Forest Hills, North Carolina. Interesting formation with the three receivers bunched to the right of Rivers on third and two. Quick pass. Leek caught this one and appears to have the first down with the mark coming at the 44-yard line before Brandon Spoon belted him. Spoon, the leading tackler for Carolina, with 63 for the year coming in. That's 23 more than any other Tar Heel. It's been a very inconsistent defensive unit for the Heels. In some games they played well, in others they played very poorly.
One thing NC State's trying to set up very early, they're trying to spread out their wide receivers and see what kind of defense UNC is going to run. Defensively, they haven't shown if they like to run a lot of zone or a lot of men. They've kind of changed it up. Norm Chow, the offensive coordinator, wants to see what they're going to do.
Four wide receivers, and they hand it off to Ray Robinson. He's the only running back who has touched the ball in the last two games for NC State. Julius Peppers made the tackle. Now the Chili's starting lineup for North Carolina State on offense. Borum, Brown, Green, Poole, and Colmer, the offensive line. Brown and Green are a little bit dinged up. Roberts with Robinson in the backfield. Wright, a terrific receiving tight end, and there's contact. Of course, Corin Robinson, the big play wide receiver. Both teams with depth at wide out, and they like to throw the ball deep. We could see quite an aerial display.
Prior to the snap, offside by the defense. That's 5 yards. It's still second down.
Eric Davis lined up inside, not as a starter, but he's in there against this spread look by North Carolina State. Defensive tackle, he's the quickest defensive tackle for Coach Torbush, and he was just a little too quick on that one.
Taking down in three now. They empty the backfield and throw a lateral to Robinson. He staggered as he caught it. That's Ray Robinson, the back. Out of bounds with the first down at the 28. Darrell Hood chased him out.
This is kind of the stamp that Norm Chow has brought to NC State. Not a lot of success running the ball early in the season. As a matter of fact, averaging under 80 yards per game rushing. But the one thing that Norm Chow always did, as we take a look at Norm, made a huge change coming from Utah to North Carolina from BYU. But that's one thing he always did at BYU, is those quick little dinks out to the flat end up just being a toss sweep.
First and 10. Ray Robinson, and he's down at the 25-yard line after pickup of three. Ryan Sims made the tackle. He's part of that defensive front four. Sims and Peppers very talented. They're looking for more from those two. Anthony Perkins and Ross McAllister also up front. The linebackers are Spoon between Hodge and Monk. And in the secondary, Waddell, Bomar, Coleman, and Hood. Second and seven. Rivers with a lot of time. Throws, and it is caught by the tight end, Willie Wright. And when we talked with Ken Browning, the defensive coordinator for North Carolina, he said one of the difficulties for him in this game is figuring out how to defend Willie Wright. You play him as a wide receiver, tight end. Technically, he's a tight end, but he looks like and plays like a wide receiver.
And this time, he's lined up as a tight end. They'll bring him out. They'll line him up in the slot. Bomar, the safety's coming over. He's got help from the defensive end. Number 95, Joey Evans, actually out there trying to cover him. You're going to lose that battle. Defensive end is not going to cover the very quick Wright.
Rivers walking toward the sideline. It looks like North Carolina State will use a timeout. No score. Each team has had the ball once, and on its first possession, an impressive drive led by Phillip Rivers for North Carolina State.
We take a look at the Dell Game Solutions when North Carolina State has the ball. Move Corin Robinson around. The game we saw last week, Sean, at Clemson, he struggled. He only had one catch going into the third quarter. They finally got the matchup they want. It resulted in a 64-yard touchdown. And utilize Ray Robinson. We already saw the little swing pass. Ray, their best running back, they've got to get him out of the backfield, try to establish some kind of run. For UNC on defense, give plenty of cushion to this guy, Corin Robinson. You cannot allow him to run by. Clemson learned that and almost lost the game because they decided to try to press him late in the game and paid the price.
Let's go down to the sidelines again. Here's Chip Tarkenton.
Well, Sean, if you will look at NC State, this is the first time they have worn all white all year. The reason is the seniors wanted to do something different, something special for this game. Coach Chuck Amato says, hey, okay, you want to wear all white? You wear all white. So far, it seems to be working pretty well.
Kind of interesting because Chuck Amato was the guy who started the white shoe defense back in 1967 as a senior. He had everybody paint their shoes white on defense. A great season. They went 9-2.
Empty backfield on third down and short. Third and less than a yard. Robinson gives it to Brian Peterson. Back to Rivers for a touchdown. A little razzle-dazzle out of the timeout from the Pack. And Brian Peterson, who was a high school quarterback, throws to the quarterback Rivers for the game's first score.
Well, we talk about razzle-dazzle. You get the defense going one way, get everybody flowing, looks like, oh, and then the reverse comes back the other way. And Brian Peterson, he's got a pretty good slugging percentage. That's his second pass of the year and his second touchdown. He threw one 38 yards to Corin Robinson against SMU.
And the extra point good from Kent Passingham. Well, Rivers has done just about everything this season for NC State. We can add this one to the list. The NC State Wolfpack off to a fast start on the touchdown reception by Phillip Rivers. Having a 55-yard drive with eight plays.
Kind of new territory for NC State. They've had to change. They had the motto finish when Chuck Amato got here. They started to start and finish 57-68. They had been outscored in first halves coming into today's game.
Another good kickoff by Austin Herbert. No chance for Michael Waddell to run it out. College football on ABC Sports, brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. By Goodyear, serious technology, freedom from worry. By Dell, providing the infrastructure to power your e-business. And by Budweiser, with the crisp, clean, refreshing taste you'll find in no other beer. From the 20, first and 10. Curry out throwing for North Carolina and on target. Bosley Allen has a first down. The first for the Heels out to the 32. A gain of 12. J.J. Washington had the coverage.
J.J., one of those guys undersized at 5'7", 174 pounds, has fought his way into the starting lineup. A freshman out of Stone Mountain, Georgia, with great technique. Finally made a big play. Had a fumble recovery for a touchdown against Georgia Tech and had an INT against Clemson. So fighting his way into the starting lineup, he's starting to pay some dividends for Chuck Amato.
Brandon Russell bouncing off Tedlers, dragging Adrian Wilson with him. Down to the 41-yard line. A gain of 9 for Brandon Russell. There's Terrence Holt, the sophomore safety who made the stop on the true freshman from Decatur, Georgia.
One thing Mike O'Kane, when we visited him this week, said that even though we haven't been that great running the ball, we don't have much balance, we have to try to establish some form of balance. A true freshman, Brandon Russell, Mike O'Kane said it's unbelievable how much football knowledge he has for a true freshman.
Andre Williams in at tailback now. He fumbles, and it's recovered by Adrian Wilson right out of the air. And State has it back near the 50-yard line. Corey Lyons knocked it out, and Wilson recovered it in midair. And the first carry of the game by another true freshman, Andre Williams. It's a turnover.
What a shame for North Carolina. Big hole up the middle, easily the first down and maybe more. Just the left hand there of Corey Lyons stripping the ball. As a freshman, you've got to start to learn when you go in amongst all those bodies and you're only fighting for half a yard, get both hands on the ball. That wasn't much of a hit to dislodge the football.
And the Tar Heels remain mistake-prone. Turnovers and the problem of the punting game cost them the game against Georgia Tech. Last time out 2 weeks ago. The fumble. Again, great field position for the Wolfpack. Ray Robinson on the run and out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Shoved out by Errol Hood. Gain of 14 for Robinson, who managed his 14 yards for the game last week at Clemson on 15 carries. They couldn't get the running game going.
And watch Corn Robinson here on the edge. Not one, but two good blocks to get the edge for his namesake, Ray Robinson. And Corn Robinson, we talked about last week, when Chuck Amato came in here, he had some problems with his new coach, but both of them reconciled, and Corn the other day said, I learned a lot from him. Plus, my mom told me to get my act together. I had to stay here at North Carolina State.
That probably had the biggest impact of all. Play action fake by Rivers. Throws to the man open. Eric Leak catches it this time. And another first down for North Carolina State, out of bounds at the 13-yard line. 23 yards. Another big play from this offense that is rapidly becoming known as a big play attack.
And you know, this is, again, we've already seen the stamp of Norm Challen, a little swing pass to Ray Robinson. This one, they use the play fake. They've already tried to establish the run, and they use Corn Robinson, one of the best big play wide receivers, to run off the defense. They, of course, have to respect his speed and leave Leak wide open.
Deep handoff to Ray Robinson. He's inside the 10. Taken down at the 8 by David Bomar and Quincy Monk. Of course, it was David Bomar who made that very famous tackle in this rivalry last year in Charlotte. 6 inches from the goal line to deny the Wolfpack the winning touchdown in the final minute and a half. And to change the fortunes of many lives. Robinson again, the ball carrier. Bomar had 19 tackles to help save his coach. In that game last week was the National Defensive Player of the Year. Robinson stopped at the 7 short of a first down. And Carl Torbush said all he did was come in as a starter midway through last year, make 52 tackles in 4 games, win the NC State game, and save my job.
So he's going to start this year. Yeah, he's not going to start on the bench. The former walk-on is going to be in my lineup.
Omar, former walk-on, now on scholarship. Third down and 3. Rivers, again with a lot of time, throwing the fade for Willie Wright over his head. Rivers, David Bomar and Michael Waddell in coverage. And the field goal unit will come on.
It's amazing, Sean, the amount of offense that this NC State team runs with a true freshman. But the big difference for Philip Rivers, Chuck Amato got him early. He graduated from high school in Alabama, came in and spent the spring. And yesterday when we spent some time, Philip Rivers said, if I wouldn't have been here for last spring, nobody would know my name yet in college football. It made that much of a difference. They're running a huge offense.
25-yard field goal try from Kent Passingham. And it is good. He's now 9 out of 12 this year in field goal, the senior from Holly Ridge, North Carolina. quick start for Chuck Amato's club out to a 10-0 lead. We head to Times Square Stadium and welcome back John Saunders.
John, thanks a lot. It's good to be back, and let's check in the Big Ten, where Minnesota is playing at Ohio State. Hadn't won there since 1949. Tellus Redmond, 20 yards on this touchdown run. Minnesota gets the victory at the Buckeyes. Northwestern also lost, so everyone in the Big Ten with at least one conference loss. That race wide open, Sean.
Indeed it is. Impressive performance by Purdue today after a tight start to that game. The Boilermakers really pulled away from Northwestern.
And I give up on trying to figure out what's going on in college football, because I had Ohio State winning that game big today at home. It's too hard to figure out. I'm throwing in the towel for the season.
Working on the towel is Philip Rivers. On the phone to Norm Chow. We've talked on the phone with some of the great quarterbacks of this generation in college football during his experience at BYU. And of all the quarterbacks you've worked with there, Rivers reminds him most of Ty Detmer.
Well, I think it's because of his playmaking ability. However, I would say that Philip Rivers has one of those all-time arms. He can make every throw. That was what really Michael Kane said made me think he could be a college quarterback when I was the head coach at NC State, was he can make every throw on the field.
Very smart, very mature, has the knack for making all the plays when you need them. This is Sam Aiken running back the Austin Herbert kickoff. He weaved his way out to the 28-yard line. Tackled by Coach Ray Jackson. Let's check Ed's Dell Game Solutions when North Carolina has the ball.
Well, we already talked about protecting the ball in the red zone. Two turnovers deep in Georgia Tech territory. Up with the muff punts, probably hurt them. Lost that game for. Shorten the game. Keep this in. We've already seen what NC State can do on offense. Establish some kind of run. Run some time off the clock. Keep the game short. For NC State on defense, win the jump balls. Ronald Curry has a great deep ball arm. He will throw it up there. Try to make some plays when that ball is in the air. They have two big safeties in Holt and Wilson. Make some interceptions.
Third possession for North Carolina. They punted once and turned it over once. Reserve defensive lineman in for the Wolfpack. With the lead, they're getting some of the frontline players a rest. And right on cue, Shane Riggs, number 92, and Jarek Hall, 93, reserve lineman, are in on the stop on Brandon Russell, and there's a late flag thrown.
Well, there was some funny business going on down in the defensive secondary of NC State. It'll be interesting to see. You had two North Carolina guys ganging up on Terrence Holt.
And Heels indicating that Jack Childress is going to signal against the pack. Buddy Green, the defensive coordinator. Part of this million-dollar staff.
That's an unsportsmanlike conduct against the white team. 15 yards from the dead ball spot. First down.
And Sean, that penalty happened 8 yards behind where the ball ended. So this turns into a 23-yard penalty. That's huge. Gets them out to the 50-yard line.
Corey Bailey is on the field now for the North Carolina offense. Wide receiver wearing number 12. Off to the left of Curry from the 50-yard line. 8 minutes left in the opening quarter. Brandon Russell to the 45-yard line. A pickup of 5, taken down by D'Antonio Burnett.
Kind of get the feeling that Carl Torbush walked up to Mike O'Kane and said, let's run some time off and give our defense a little rest on the sideline. Not a whole lot of depth on that North Carolina or North Carolina State defensive side of the ball. They have to get these guys off their feet a little bit. 80-plus degrees down on the field, and they've been on the field a lot for Carolina.
Second and 5. Russell pulled down by Corey Lyons at the 39. It's a first down.
And this guy's getting better and better. Early in camp, Michael Kane said, I did a disservice to him because I was trying to get everybody some reps at tailback. We had two true freshmen who were figuring into playing time and another sophomore. I was trying to get them all some experience. But as they started to realize that this is going to be their guy this year, started to get him more time with that first string offense, and it's starting to pay some dividends. He's running very hard.
Some of the starters back into the defensive front now after a couple of tiring here first down. Whoa! Adrian Wilson leveled Brandon Russell. The coaches told us last week that Wilson's their hardest hitter, and if you need any evidence, there it is.
Take a look at this and take a listen to this hit. That's plastic on plastic. Squaring up, Adrian Wilson has linebacker size at 6'3", 212 pounds. He also has nearly a 40-inch vertical jump. I would say he exploded on Brandon Russell.
New wide receivers as Curry goes out of the shotgun. And flings to the far sideline, too high. Jamal Jones was open, the redshirt freshman from Washington, D.C., but Curry was off target, and he's been off target on a couple of throws to that far sideline.
Boy, you get the feeling that NC State is rather glad that they're playing a team that huddles up. Last week, Sean, that game was amazing how often Clemson lined up and ran offensive plays. They ended up with 95 on the day. NC State now able to change in some personnel on third and long, try to get the matchups they want, take a little breather.
Well, yes, Buddy Green, if he was concerned about fatigue, some of the defensive starters played 120 snaps when you count special teams. But he said, no, we're in great shape. Curry has a lot of running room, has a first down, out of bounds at the 19-yard line. An 18-yard run by Curry.
Over there trying to run him out of bounds was LeVar Fisher, who grew up wanting to play for North Carolina, had the hat, had the shirt, came to North Carolina's camp. There's LeVar giving chase. That's an awfully quick quarterback. NC State is awfully sick of seeing guys who can run under center. They had Antoine Randall-El. They had to play against Indiana. Last week against Woodrow Dantzler. And now they have to see Ronald Curry, and LeVar Fisher just can't catch up to the fleet-footed Curry.
6 minutes left, first quarter, 10-0, North Carolina State. Option pitch. Russell down to the 15-yard line. LeVar Fisher and Brian Williams combining on the stop. One of the reasons Fisher wanted to go to NC State instead of Carolina that he grew up cheering for was the number 44. So Brandon Spoon already had 44. Another factor was Mack Brown was leaving to go to Texas. And he grew up a Tar Heel fan and joined the enemy.
Of course, in the NFL, guys come in. I played for the Arizona Cardinals. Seth Joyner came in. I was wearing 59. He made a little deal with me, side deal, to get my jersey. I parted with it very happily for that deal. Yeah. I'd have to claim it as taxes.
You're going to have to now anyway. Eighth play of the drive. Second down. Russell. Stopped for very little. Spun around by LeVar Fisher. He's one of those who the coach has told us played 120 snaps last week at Clemson. And he had a brilliant ball game. 19 tackles, a forced fumble, a couple of sacks. An amazing game.
And talking to him yesterday, the only play he remembers is when he got shook out of his cleats by Woodrow Dantzler. An amazing game. Here's a look at what these guys did. 112.
Well, the coaches did exaggerate a little bit. We took the official numbers. Not quite 120, but close enough. Enough to wear you out. Curry looking toward the end zone as a man open. First down, out of bounds at the five, Sam Aiken. Well, we expect a shootout today, and it is certainly shaping up like one here in the first quarter. A 10-yard gain and a first down on the completion. Curry to Aiken, the sophomore from Kenansville, North Carolina.
Really nice job by North Carolina on this drive, mixing up the run and the pass. Here, a controlled rollout. You have protection from an offensive lineman who pulls. And it's just a mirror route where the wide receiver is running the same path as Ronald Curry.
Russell fighting for extra yardage. He got down to the one. Looked like he'd be stacked up for no gain. He made it inside the two-yard line. Looks like they're going to put the ball down closer to the two. Again, LeVar Fisher, the bottom of the pile, with Corey Smith also into the tackle.
This is where Chuck Amato has to be licking his chops a little bit, because Ronald Curry has had some problems in the red zone this year, throwing the ball away. Every single one of his five interceptions have come on the plus side of the 50-yard line.
Robinson in at fullback, leading the way. Touchdown. Brandon Russell gets North Carolina on the board.
Russell. His first career touchdown comes against the crosstown rival, North Carolina State Wolfpack. Great blocking up front. Tiptoes in, but a great drive using this guy's ability to get tough yardage.
And Jeff Reed adds the extra point. It's early in the game, but you get the feeling North Carolina really needed that score. It's 10-7 Wolfpack. Russell, the true freshman with his first collegiate touchdown, having an impressive 11-play, 72-yard drive, and it's 10-7, North Carolina State. Jeff Reed, the former walk-on, put on scholarship this season, will kick off.
It's amazing how that affects your eligibility. He immediately became a junior instead of a senior when he got a scholarship.
When you're on scholarship, I'll stick around a while longer. Go to school on their dime. He's a communications major. Forbes wanted to see him kick in game situations this year before giving him a scholarship. Wanted to make sure he could handle the pressure. Big difference between practice and game situations for the kicker. Julius Patterson. Nice run back out to the 28-yard line. Tackled by David Thornton. Next Saturday, ABC Sports has a full slate of college football at 3:30 Eastern. Some of you will see number 7 Florida State hosting Virginia, plus another regional action. Michigan State takes on Michigan, Texas Tech versus Kansas State, or Texas A&M versus Iowa State, or Missouri versus Texas, and USC versus Stanford. It's all part of our college football Saturday on ABC. And of course, all of those games available on pay-per-view by calling your local cable or satellite company. Sean Williams injured on the play for North Carolina. He's a reserve linebacker. Well, let's go back to Times Square Stadium. Here's John Saunders.
Sean, here on the Burger King update, what a year for JT Thatcher of Oklahoma. 6 interceptions, a punt return for a touchdown, and here after a K-State touchdown, he takes off and gets it deep. 93 yards down to the 2-yard line, sets up Seth Luttrell on the next play. 10-7, the lead for Oklahoma. It's early. Sean.
Indeed it is. Great atmosphere in Manhattan today.
And now we see NC State is going to the no-huddle offense. Chuck Amato saw enough of that against Clemson last week. So he's decided to take a little page from Tommy Bowden's playbook.
Ray Robinson takes the lateral and gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Errol Hood made the tackle.
Well, I guess Chuck Amato and Norm Chow deciding what worked against us, we're going to start using, going with the no huddle again. A true freshman quarterback having to make a lot of adjustments. Came in the spring and now running the no huddle offense and looking very good while running it. That's one thing this guy does have a lot of, is composure.
Second and 9. By far the poorest field position of the 3 possessions of the game for the Wolfpack. Leak reverses his field. Rivers trying to help him with a block. But it's Errol Hood making the tackle right along the line of scrimmage. Perhaps a gain of a yard, but that's all.
I'll give North Carolina a little credit. That's a play that North Carolina State, that's the 3rd time they've given the exact same look. Handed off to a receiver. Kent Browning, the defensive coordinator, finally getting his guys to settle down, stay home. Sometimes defenses get a little overexcited and can over-pursue a play. Your backside defensive end and linebacker have to stay home for that type of misdirection.
Rivers with a flag down, dumps it off short. Jermaine Simmons stopped at the 32-yard line. He's a reserve fullback. He's short of the first down by about 5 yards. Quincy Monk and Robert Harris, a couple of linebackers, made the tackle. And they'll likely turn it down if it's against the Wolfpack, but it's against the heels. A big mistake for North Carolina.
Offsides, defense lined in the neutral zone. 5 yards, it's still 3rd down.
one of those mental errors. You just got to be able to look down the line of scrimmage, see where that ball is. Defensive ends always trying to get as crowded to the line of scrimmage as possible. You just got to peek down and see if you're on sides or not.
Big penalty against the defense that really needs to have good things happen to it to get some confidence back after the difficulties against Georgia Tech in an inconsistent punch all year. Now a manageable third down and three. Rivers lofts it ahead. Tremaine Simmons with a big first down for the Wolfpack. And a very late flag thrown near midfield. Simmons went down at the 41-yard line of Carolina. Devontae Coleman made the tackle. 26-yard gain. Probably a late hit or an unsportsmanlike conduct, as that flag was thrown after the tackle was made.
And he's calling over Scott Kustra, who's playing for basically the first time this year. Hurt his knee during training camp.
We have a first down attained by the offense. We have a personal foul for unnecessary roughness by the offense. Penalized 15 yards. It's first and 10.
And these are the types of things. I know Scott Kustra has not had a chance to play this year. He wants to go out and be aggressive and prove something. But this block happens well behind the ball. And Chuck Amato calls over Kustra and makes sure that the sophomore knows that, listen, I appreciate your aggressiveness, but you can't make those types of mistakes that far behind the ball.
Well, the penalties were a problem last week at Clemson. 10 penalties against the Wolfpack, the loss to the Tigers. And two here in the first quarter today, which has a minute and a half remaining. Ray Robinson on first and 10, gets back across midfield and fights for a first down to the 45-yard line of the Tar Heels, where Devontae Coleman, the safety, made the stop, the sophomore from Kinston, North Carolina.
Tremaine Simmons has had to play everything. He came here as a linebacker. He played some tight end. He lined up at tight end a minute ago on that out and up route where he got the first down, and that time he lines up as an I-back fullback. This guy, Mr. Versatility early on for the Wolfpack.
Up at the backfield this time, leading the way for Ray Robinson through a big hole. And another first down. Out of bounds at the 34-yard line, Errol Hood, the quarterback, made the tackle. So after struggling with the running game against Clemson, the Wolfpack running with efficiency against the Heels.
And there's Simmons again. A great cut block on Quincy Monk, the outside linebacker. Monk had one-on-one coverage on Tremaine Simmons on the pass that resulted in the first down that was backed up with the Kustra late hit penalty. But Tremaine Simmons early on, a guy who hadn't been used much by NC State, really getting into the fold for North Carolina State.
State's rush for 48 yards now. Run nine running plays and nine pass plays. A pitch back to Robinson, and he's followed after a short gain to the 33 by Cedric Hodge, the senior from Atlanta, Georgia, who during the off week was added to the watch list for the Butkus Award, which goes to the best linebacker in the nation. The Butkus committee impressed by what he's done so far this year. Monday night, the Jaguars, perhaps their playoff hopes hanging in the balance now. Who thought you'd be saying that this early in the season? They're taking on their rivals, the Titans, the team that's beaten them four times in a row. It's Monday night at 9 Eastern time, Monday Night Football, right here on ABC Sports. Under a minute left in the opening quarter. Rivers throws, blocked by Corin Robinson. And that's a rarity.
John, that's the third pass we've seen dropped when the receiver has to look back towards the quarterback with that sun right over our left shoulder here. I'm not so sure. I'm not trying to make excuses for guys
catch
making the drops. You know I'm going to stick up for the player every now and then.
Yes. And Rivers 6 out of 9, and without the drops, he might be perfect. Cotre Jackson comes into the ball game now as the running back. Lined up to the right of Rivers. Four receivers spread the formation on third down and 8. Rivers pass deflected up in the air and incomplete. Deflected by Hodge. He chased after it and tried to intercept it. He batted it too far away from himself. And the Tar Heel defense holds at least for the moment. No sign of the punting unit just yet. Being sent on by Chuck Amato.
You already mentioned Cedric Hodge was added to the Butkus list. And when we talked to Ken Browning, the defensive coordinator, This guy's been a solid player for them for the last 3 years, but they really didn't expect this type of senior year out of the 6'4", 235-pounder out of Atlanta, Georgia. He has really stepped up his game. Mercedes Perry, another outside linebacker, was lost for the season early on, and Cedric Hodge has really stepped up.
They're going for it on fourth down and 8. From the 33-yard line of Carolina, Rivers has to get rid of it. Throws, intercepted! Picked off by Dexter Reed. First career interception for Reed. Ken Browning's defense did not have an interception in the first four games of the year. They got two against Georgia Tech in the last ball game, and they have one here in the first quarter on a big play.
Watch Willie Wright. He is the guy that Brandon Spoon ends up covering him one-on-one. He's the guy that Phillip Rivers was looking at the whole way. That's why he came back late to Corin Robinson, and Reed was standing there reading the quarterback in zone coverage, but it was the great coverage by Brandon Spoon, the middle linebacker, on Willie Wright. We mentioned that matchup. A great job by Spoon caused a late throw by Rivers.
Perry comes out throwing. He has no receiver. Needs to get rid of it. Throws a bomb. Incomplete. How far was that one on the run? The receiver's at the 25. Ronald Curry had to be behind the line of scrimmage, so he was behind his own 20. That's about 55, 56 yards in the air on the run in a perfect spiral. He took a pretty good lick as well.
This guy does not lack for arm strength. Not only on the run, well, he did take it in the chops there. That looked like D'Antonio Burnett, who hit him up underneath the chin, but Michael Kane knows this guy's got plenty of arm strength. Wants to settle him down sometimes, take the underneath, but boy, that kind of ability, even Michael Kane, as good a quarterback coach as he is, he can't coach that.
Option, Russell, lots of running room, first down. Out to the 31, LeVar Fisher made the tackle. It'll likely be the last play of the quarter.
You know, Sean, when we were here a couple of weeks ago, one of the biggest conversations was this offensive line of North Carolina, how inexperienced they were. But the coaches kept talking about they only had one guy who really had prior starting experience. But the coaches talked about they have the ability, they just need the experience. They're starting to really take over up front.
That's the end of the first quarter. North Carolina State has a 10-7 lead over North Carolina. McDonough, Ed Cunningham, Chip Tarkenton back in Chapel Hill. On this warm mid-October afternoon, terrific action-packed first quarter. Tar Heels first and 10 to begin the second quarter. And it's that man, LeVar Fisher again, running down Brandon Russell for little or no gain. Well, he had 19 tackles last week against Clemson. He might surpass that total at the rate he's going today.
You know, the amazing part about LeVar Fisher is the speed with which he tracks down ball carriers. 6'1", 223 pounds. North Carolina wanted him to play fullback because of that speed. He had a forced fumble against Georgia Tech that was scooped up and scored by J.J. Washington, really turned that ball game around, where he came completely from the backside on a toss sweep, did the exact same thing right there. He can really track it.
He dropped about 17 pounds during the winter conditioning. His body fat from 12% down to about 5%. Perry throws, just got it off in time to Jamal Jones. He's short of a first down to the 39. Short by 2 yards. Here's Chip.
Well, guys, Coach Michael Kane has found something in the NC State defense. That's why they're running the down-the-line option where Curry takes it and pitches it back. They think they've got the NC State defense kind of hooked in the bowl to where they can get outside, and that's why they're having success with that play.
Well, I think with a guy like Ronald Curry, you know, NC State was hoping that they weren't, that North Carolina wouldn't pick anything up from Clemson and all the running they did with Woody Dantzler. Well, they're keyed up to get after him passing the ball, and now North Carolina making him pay for it, flicking it on the option.
Third down and 2, play clock at 2 seconds as Perry takes the snap and throws short of Bosley Allen. He was wide open in first down range. Wasn't a great throw, but from our vantage point, it did look catchable for Allen. But if it hit him in the numbers, he might have been able to run for a while after the catch as well.
But this is the one thing Michael Kane says that he really struggles with
that
Ronald
wasn't catchable.
Curry. But that ball, Sean, does not have to be thrown there. There wasn't pressure. He's got to just set his feet and get it down there. But Michael Kane working on the intermediate short passes sometimes Ronald Curry takes those for granted.
It's a fake. Lafferty taken down back at the 27-yard line by Brian Williams, the starting cornerback.
Boy, if you're going to run this play, there's too many guys for NC State. They have three outside rushers. John, they should have audibled out of this play. There's no way that you're going to get that play off with three rushers that wide. Somebody, there's got to be an automatic read. The up back or the punter has to say safe, safe, and go ahead and punt that ball.
With all the problems they had 2 weeks ago in the kicking game, you'd think they'd be content just to get punts off at this point before they take the next step to faking punts. NC State's been a great punt block team with 12 block punts over the last 3 years. This time they take down the punter during an attempted fake. The handoff on the reverse to Corin Robinson. Rivers gives him a block. And Robinson's down to the 11-yard line. That's a gain of 16 on the run. Defonte Coleman made the tackle. And it's also a play that turns momentum back against you. You got back in the game. The game had stabilized a little bit for you offensively and defensively with the Tar Heels. Now you throw the momentum right back to the Wolfpack.
And it's not like this Wolfpack offense needs any help with how much they've improved over the last four or five ball games with this freshman quarterback. They don't need any help.
Ray Robinson backed up at their gain of two. Of course, it's in the kind of field position and down and distance where you're likely to run a fake. You want to go back to Chuck Amato's decision, going for it on fourth and eight late in the first quarter. They were the 33-yard line, and Ed, you can understand his thinking. They don't have a proven long-range field goal kicker. It would have been a 50-yard attempt. If you punt, you might not gain much. You have an offense that can make big plays. Why not go for the 8 yards?
Yeah, and you end up giving the ball up on the inside the 20-yard line anyway, which is about the best you can hope for with a punt.
There's after the fifth interception of the year by Rivers. And nine from just outside the 10. Rivers away from the heat. Lofts it to the end zone. Touchdown. Brian Peterson. NC State strikes quickly after the aborted fake punt.
Well, you know, Sean, Phillip Rivers is not exactly the fleetest footed quarterback in the NC and the ACC, but Joey Evans, the defensive end, basically goes unblocked. And it just seems every time Phillip Rivers makes a play, he has just enough speed, just enough elusiveness to get away from people. This guy, I tell you, you run out of things to say, but right there, just making a huge play to get away from Joey Evans.
And passing him adds the extra point. Phillip Rivers to Brian Peterson. And the lead back to 10 for the Wolfpack. Two touchdowns in the game for North Carolina State. The first was Brian Peterson throwing to the quarterback Phillip Rivers, and Rivers just returned the favor with a touchdown pass to Peterson after a botched fake punt by North Carolina. Austin Herbert kicks off. Sam Aiken and Kevin Knight. This one returnable for Aiken from the goal line. A lot of ground in returning it out to the 27-yard line. Chased out by Craig Moody. College football on ABC Sports is brought to you by the makers of the all-new Dodge Caravan. Dodge, different. By Nortel Networks, they're building the new high-performance internet. By Chili's, I want my Chili's baby back ribs only at Chili's. And by Courtyard by Marriott, the hotel designed by business travelers. From their own 27. Brandon Russell spins across the 30. Brian Williams and Nate Goodson combining on the stop of Russell. Goodson's a junior from Roxboro, North Carolina. Another guy who dropped about 20 pounds during their winter conditioning program.
That winter conditioning program was overseen by Todd Stroud, a former starting nose guard for Coach Amato at Florida State. He had a really big impact, not just on their conditioning, but their strength. 400-pound bench pressers went up 13 players in the final battle.
Curry's pass too high for Russell, and he got Russell killed by Adrian Wilson with that throw. Wilson had the opportunity to line up Russell, and he didn't miss it. And Curry continues to be very inaccurate with the short ones, although the way Wilson was snipping that one out, it might be a good thing it wasn't caught by Russell. It was going to be a long.
Oh, man. That's not a car wreck waiting to happen. When you lay that ball out there, Adrian Wilson, who's sneaking up close to the line of scrimmage from his strong safety position, going with the back out of the backfield, you can't really be laying out your wide receivers and running backs that much.
Third down and six. Curry throws too high. And Ed, you could just almost see it, the body language of the Tar Heels, and you could certainly feel it in the crowd. The fake punt, the subsequent score, took all the air out of this Carolina crowd.
Well, North Carolina was trying to get a big play, although I just don't understand why you'd run a fake punt that deep. They've had problems as J.J. Washington looks like he's down for North Carolina State, starting cornerback. But you do feel that, Sean. I mean, the body language of that offense, it just looked like they weren't running the crisp routes. Everybody just kind of jogging off the field after three and out.
And definitely some of the energy has gone out of the crowd as well. Crowd very quiet now as they tend to Washington. The good news is he has been moving around.
And this is not a defense that can afford to lose anybody. They only get 15 or 16 different players on the field because of the lack of depth. Only 71 scholarship players out of the 85 available to Chuck Amato.
Coming up on Valvoline Halftime 2000, John Saunders and Terry Bowden of the scores and highlights from around the country. Plus, they'll go out of bounds with college football historian Vino Cook. They're all coming up from Times Square Stadium at the half. Not to say another day of surprises, but nothing is surprising anymore in college football as they help Washington off.
Not able to put pressure on that left leg. And he is one of the best cover guys. Him and Brian Williams make a very good tandem, but we've mentioned the depth, the lack of depth for North Carolina State. They might have to start rotating some things around in that secondary.
These are the block kicks we were talking about earlier. 12 punts and four field goals, including the blocked field goal last week against Clemson. Corin Robinson back for what we anticipate will be a punt from Lafferty. And he just did get it off, and it's a good kick. Riding Robinson back to the 23. Flags down. As Robinson avoided the first two tacklers, the flag was thrown. Robinson finally went down to the 37-yard line. Jason Beeman, the snapper, made the tackle. Brian Williams was the man who put the heat on Lafferty. He was the man who tackled Lafferty on the fake attempt last time around.
Sean, it looked like the coverage men from North Carolina gave plenty of space for Corin Robinson. I believe it's a block in the back by Rod Johnson right here. Or excuse me, that's 32. Yeah, you can't even put your hands on the back. That's Julius Patterson, a cornerback, who just put his hands on the back of the defender and altered his position on the field. And anytime you're going to just stick those hands out, you're right there. The officials can see it.
There's also a personal foul against the Tar Heels. They're going to kick it over again.
And you got to figure Corin Robinson is tired of seeing guys blocking the back when he's returning kicks. He had a 97-yard.
We have offsetting fouls. We have a block in the back by the return team. We have a personal foul by the blue team. The penalty was accepted, creating offsetting fouls. Fourth down.
Corin Robinson had a 97-yard kickoff return for a touchdown against Georgia Tech that was brought back because an illegal block in the back. And that one there by Patterson probably didn't need the block to make those two Tar Heels miss.
Well, Lafferty back in the spotlight. It was Blake Ferguson, the true freshman who was their punter, who had the drop snap against Georgia Tech and had another one blocked. The coaches led us to believe Ferguson would be the punter this week, but it's been Lafferty throughout this day. That's a line drive kick. Robinson back to the 26. Across the 35. And it was the punter Lafferty who made the tackle at the 39-yard line. A 44-yard punt, but a 35-yard return.
What an excellent job by Corin Robinson. Everything is set up to the left. The picket fence is over here. Watch his move right there. Made North Carolina think he was going back to the right. Gave just an extra second for that fence to be set up to the outside. That little move right there bought this big return for Corin Robinson because North Carolina had him pinned in. What a nice job of seeing the entire field by number three.
Interesting formation here. They line up Corin Robinson with the rest of the offense off to the left. The flag thrown. Will Chapman made the tackle. They had Robinson lined up in a shotgun. The rest of the offense, including Rivers, off to Robinson's left.
And they fooled themselves.
Yeah, they outsmarted themselves.
Illegal formation by the offense. Not enough men on the line. That penalty is refused. Second down.
Oh, that's loss of one on the play.
Excuse me, Sean. That's one of the problems when you start running these crazy offensive. They ran a similar formation against Georgia Tech. Were able to get the playoff for about a 5-yard gain, but there's so many big guys out there, they're not sure where to line up and not getting enough guys up on the line of scrimmage.
Robinson up the middle. Ray Robinson, first down Wolfpack. Down to the 21-yard line. Gain of 18.
And Brandon Spoon of North Carolina is down grabbing his left leg. This is a guy who missed most of last year. Ruptured his left biceps tendon. Got a medical red shirt. Came back this year. Would not have come back, he said. He had a long talk with Carl Torbush about him returning as the head coach and said he would have had to decide whether he'd returned or not if Coach Torbush would have been fired. And this is a guy they've already lost Mercedes Perry early in the season, another starting linebacker, and him being helped off doesn't look good with that right leg hanging.
Well, he's their best defensive player, perhaps the best player on the entire team. Robert Harris, number 55, will take his place. And obviously, the coaches don't want to make excuses for the 3-8 last year, but Spoon missed almost the entire year, as did Curry. And as Carl Torbush said, you can go on the playground and pick up sides. Those would be the first two guys to be picked.
Yeah, number 44 and number one would go awfully quick in that draft.
And now Harris with a very big shoes to fill. The middle linebacker, Ray Robinson. Plenty of yardage before he was touched, and he was hit pretty hard when he was touched at the 12-yard line by Defonte Coleman and Robert Harris. That's a quality gain on first down for the Wolfpack, threatening to score again.
And our man right here, Jarvis Borman, gets a great block on the edge. Tight end gets a great block on Cedric Hodge. Just really good point blocking. Once you get those shoulders turned to those defensive linemen back towards the middle of the field, they're beat.
Huge hole. First down, Ray Robinson to the 5-yard line. He now has 84 yards rushing on just 13 carries. Cedric Hodge made the tackle. First and goal, Wolfpack, threatening to open it up with 10 minutes left in the first half, already leading by 10.
And look at the pressure they're putting on North Carolina. North Carolina having a hard time matching up personnel-wise.
They're trying to get a timeout and did not. Ray Robinson diving for the pylon and did not get it. Carolina coaches were signaling for a timeout with personnel running on the field just prior to the snap. It's a gain of 3 for Robinson. Will be second and goal from the 2.
Very difficult when you're down inside the 5-yard line. It's a long way to run for Ken Browning's defense. When he's trying to match personnel with Norm Chow, that's a long way for his guys to run on and off the field. North Carolina State knew that and went with a hurry-up offense.
Second and goal from the 2. Tight formation. Robinson trying to run wide. Touchdown, North Carolina State.
Well, against Clemson, Ray Robinson had a rough outing. He managed 14 rushing yards on 15 carries, and Norm Chow said, we have to try to establish this guy. Corin Robinson, Ray Robinson, both of them can be big-time players for us, and North Carolina State is establishing him early.
The extra point good by Passingham. Ray Robinson, the junior from Hilton Head, South Carolina. A two-yard touchdown run, and it's the Wolfpack by 17 in the first half. Back in Chapel Hill, the good news for North Carolina State, a 17-point lead. The bad news is that J.J. Washington was just carted off. And the report from Chip Tarkenton is they fear he has a torn left ACL.
And good news on the other side, Brandon Spoon, who had to be helped off the field, was just kicked in the knees over there walking it off, and will be able to go back in when North Carolina takes the field on defense.
It was a 10-7 game when North Carolina tried to fake a punt. And it's now 24-7, North Carolina State. Momentum clearly on its side, and that continues as Sam Aiken can't reach the 20 on the run back. Fired up pack, stopping him at the 17-yard line, led by Julius Patterson. Jericho Cotchery also in on the play. Time now for our Aflac trivia question, brought to you, ironically enough, by Aflac. And we want to know who holds the single game record for passing yards in this series.
I cheated.
You cheated.
Yeah, I get up here
and qualify yourself.
I have. I've raised the white flag. I'm out.
Ronald Curry setting up the screen to Brandon Russell, and there's Adrian Wilson throwing him for a loss back at the 7. That took so long to develop, you could see Wilson starting about 15 yards away, just sprinting at Russell before Curry even lofted the ball up into the air.
Now, the offensive line, Sean, of North Carolina got caught peeking down into the defensive backfield. This screen is set up. It takes a while to get over there, but Wagstaff, a couple of his buddies, waiting to get over there, and Adrian Wilson sneaks between them. How many big hits for him? That's three huge hits for the 6'3", 212-pound strong safety.
Loss of 8, 2nd and 18. Russell out to the 10. Going back to one play, Edrick Smith made the tackle. We talked about how deflated all the Tar Heels and their fans seem to be after the fake punt, and they certainly have not recovered yet.
No, and then you start going backwards on offense, and the heat's going to continue to go up on Coach Torbush and his staff. After last year finishing 3-8, there was a lot of pressure on them, and of course this is the biggest game of the year in this state for these fans, and they want to see a win. And it's like they almost forget that Carolina has won 7 in a row. Maybe it's the other guy's turn.
Back hasn't won in this rivalry since 92. Curry bouncing off and picking up a first down. Corey Lyons finally made the tackle. They had Curry behind the line of scrimmage. He turned it into a gain of 20 and a much-needed first down for North Carolina.
You know, Sean, he's one of those athletes that when he gets going, he doesn't really look like he's moving that fast because he is so smooth. Watch him weave through traffic, using his vision, head on a swivel, finding guys, setting him up with the planted foot, moving back inside. Doesn't look like he's moving real fast because he is so fluid when he's running.
He has doubled as a guard on the basketball team. Some of those moves we just saw to get to the basket as well. Late hit flag thrown. Curry was down with a first down out to the 42. He gained 12 on the run. And they might tack on 15 against LeVar Fisher for a late hit. Curry slow to get up. And the medical staff's on the field looking at him.
LeVar Fisher's going to come over the top on this one. This is that option that Chip Tarkenton had talked about that North Carolina thought they could run, and they did. This time the defensive end gets up the field.
Personal foul by the defense, 15 yards, first down.
And I don't know that it was so much the late hit, Sean, but LeVar Fisher comes flying in there with his helmet into the back of Ronald Curry. Good call by the officials. You're looking out for the safety of the players.
There's Antoine Black, the backup quarterback. Tough sentence for me. Let's try again. Antoine Black, the backup quarterback.
And he's a guy who's
attempted that sentence.
Well, he used to play safety. That would have been easier for you to say. But he was a starter back in 98 at safety. All the problems last year, quarterback Ronald Curry gets hurt, Luke Heward gets hurt. He gave up his starting job as a safety to come over, plays two games as the starting quarterback last year in 99, and then he is be felled by Mono and has to sit out the last couple of games. A very exciting athlete, sub 4.5 in the 40. Watch them run the ball with him at quarterback.
He's a senior, Central South Carolina. After the walk-off of the penalty, it's first and 10 North Carolina at the NC State 43. Three wide receivers, Black out of the shotgun. Starting with an easy play, the handoff to Russell. Down to the 40, Corey Smith made the tackle.
What an interesting week of practice for Antoine Black. There's been a lot of talk about him. He's played a couple of downs as a wide receiver this year. Such a good athlete that Michael Kane and his staff just want to get him on the field. This week he had to play a lot of wide receiver because of the injury to Corey Bailey. And now he has to go in when the game's in a very crucial point, 6:50 left in the second quarter, and he practiced all week at wide receiver. Now he's a quarterback.
Second down and 8. Russell took the handoff, bounced it outside. Corey Lyons drives him back from the 38, helped from Terrence Holt. Gain of 2 more. Chip Tarkenton tells us that Curry had the wind knocked out of him. And he's standing on the sideline without any medical personnel around him, looking like he's ready to come back in right now.
He's doing what's called the creep, Sean. When you're ready to go back in the game, you creep and you kind of nudge the coach. He knows you're there, but you continue to step on his toes to make sure he sends you back in.
Well, I think if he's ready to go, they put him back in there. This is an important drive for them with 17-point deficit. Momentum against them. 6 minutes left, first half. 3rd and 5. Quarterback draw out of the shotgun. Black lunging toward the 33 and might have picked up the first down with the lunge. Sean Locklear and D'Antonio Burnett combined on the stop. And they actually put the ball back right around the 33 or short of it.
Looked like with that stretch, he might have got a little extra yardage out of that. I don't know about that spot.
Yeah, they've moved the ball back.
Uh-huh.
The official on the far sideline was running in to mark the ball, was running inside the 33-yard line, closer to the 32, but they didn't adhere to his placement of the ball.
And here's a spot where exactly where North Carolina State was earlier in the game. Now, they were going for a 4th and 7, but this, even if they don't make it, you would think that Coach Corbush and his staff would go for it here on 4th down.
Yeah, they have to go for it. And again, a long way to go in the first half, but another important play. 4th and inches.
Might as well not get fancy, just something straight ahead like a sneak.
Antoine Black is still the quarterback. He keeps it. Flag down.
Well, the left side of the offensive line come flying down inside. Lewis Marchetti, Cam Holland, I'm not sure which one, but somebody got off early on the left side of that offensive line for North Carolina.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, 5 yards, it's still 4th down.
So tough as an offensive lineman, that defensive line, they've got their face mask about 1/2 inch off the ground. You've got to try to get, that's Lewis Marchetti, the left tackle, just got down there a little early. He's got to get all the way down inside and try to get on that 3 technique over the left guard to get started a little early.
North Carolina has called a timeout. Ronald Curry back on the field for North Carolina for this 4th down and 6. Throws the slant. Corey Bailey. First down. Down to the 16-yard line. Well, they want Bailey to see limited action with the hamstring injury. They had him in for the very big play, and he made the big play. A 22-yard pickup to extend the possession. He had Terrence Holt in coverage.
And give a lot of credit to Mike O'Kane for this call. He got his big-time receiver, Corey Bailey's little gimp, against James Walker, a freshman cornerback who's in there because J.J. Washington, the starter, is out with a torn ACL.
Brandon Russell through the middle of the 14-yard line. That was a good throw by Curry. He's not been very accurate on those short and intermediate balls today. just back on the field after getting the wind knocked out of him. He had to be accurate, and he was.
And again, it's all about matchups, and this is a guy who knows about the other team. Michael Kane was the head coach, recruited every guy just about that's out there from North Carolina State, knew he would have a mismatch.
Seven down and seven. 4.5 minutes left in the first half. The Wolfpack with a 17-point lead. Curry again throws a slant, incomplete, flag down. James Walker, that true freshman Ed was speaking of a moment ago, was bumping Bosley Allen, and he drew the flag.
Well, you got to give the freshman credit. Last time he gave a little too much space to Corey Bailey, gave up the first time down. This time
pass,
he's going to tighten up.
Defense, penalty to the spot, first down.
Chuck Amato's thin defense got a lot thinner. J.J. Washington, a guy who fought himself into the starting lineup with great technique, and now James Walker has to come in, and North Carolina going right after the wounded state defense.
And they don't have a lot of depth in that secondary. Quentin Allen, a redshirt freshman who'd been playing some, has been out with an injury the last couple of weeks. And now J.J. Washington out. Russell bangs down near the 5-yard line on first and goal. Jeff Fisher made the stop. Fisher's a senior from Coatesville, Pennsylvania. Came out of the same high school, Coatesville Area High School, that produced Richard Hamilton, a terrific basketball player at the University of Connecticut, who's gone on to the NBA. Jeff's an accomplished musician. Plays keyboards, bass guitar, drums. Actively involved as a musician in his church.
Curry kicks.
Nifty run for a touchdown. Didn't look like there was any running room when he first started to his left, but he found a couple of creases and scores from 6 yards out.
Ronald Curry's one of those guys that guys like you and I, Sean, we don't like because they just make everything look easy. Watch him just step over people here. Okay, that's nothing. I'm just falling into the end zone for six. It's easy for me to throw the ball 70 yards down the field.
The extra point up and good from Jeff Reed. 6-yard touchdown run by Ronald Curry. Coach Torbush and the Heels are back within 10. Michael Kane told us one of the nice things about not being a head coach, going back to being an assistant, is you're much more involved with the X's and O's. And that's the situation right now for O'Kane and Ronald Curry after the touchdown drive by the Tar Heels. It has to be a very strange feeling for Mike O'Kane. He's tried to play this down, but for 14 years he was wearing the red on the other sideline. This was his bitter rival. And now he's wearing the blue hat, looking across at so many people he knows and loves.
And he didn't hide it. He said, this is a tough week. 5 years from now, it wouldn't have been. But this is a little early. Those wounds are still open.
Kickoff by Jeff Reed, bouncing through the end zone. And the Wolfpack from its own 20. Next Saturday, ABC Sports with a full slate of college football at 3:30 Eastern will be in Tallahassee to watch the Seminoles against the Virginia Cavaliers, Michigan State, Michigan, Texas Tech, Kansas State, Texas A&M, Iowa State, Missouri, Texas. Some of the possibilities out of the Big 12 and USC and Stanford in parts of the country, all part of our college football Saturday, next Saturday on ABC. Not the huge numbers from Phillip Rivers we've become accustomed to, but he's been very effective. Hands it off to Robinson. And the crowd back into it now, fired up as Julius Peppers made the tackle.
This defense, you know, the offense has kind of done its part. They got put in a hole, the defense did, after the fake punt that went awry down deep in their own territory. And now the defense, Quincy Monk comes running off. Sims, one of top defensive tackles in the ACC. And Julius Peppers, a great athlete on the outside, making a play.
Brandon Spoon is on the field for the defense. That's a lateral to Ray Robinson. And he can't elude the pursuing Tar Heels. Spoon and Anthony Perkins combining on the tackle. It'll be third down and long.
And North Carolina's in a spot where they can't slow this clock down, Sean. Only one timeout left because of some confusion they had in their offense earlier. But you mentioned body language after that turn of events after the punt. That body language has changed drastically for the guys in Carolina Blue.
Another big play here. Four receivers spread the formation as they shift the tight end right out with three wide receivers. Long count by Rivers. He's in trouble and sacked inside the 10. Julius Peppers. And a flag thrown. That flag just came out well after the play was over.
Outside blitz by Cedric Hodge. He's going to come from the outside. I like the aggressive call by Ken Browning, the defensive coordinator. On third and a mile, you figured he could drop back and play some zone. Hodge might get half of that sack. Julius Peppers
will. Unsportsmanlike against the defense.
Oh,
15
Sean.
Yards, and it's still fourth down.
Sean, you can't continue to make plays like that and then hurt yourself with just stupid errors.
Well, it's not enough to get him a first down, but the fact of the matter is that we were talking about this during a commercial break. This team of Carl Torbush makes way too many mistakes to be a good football team right now. Penalties, mental mistakes, coaching mistakes, it seems to us. Problems in the kicking game, penalties. They find a way to make way too many mistakes.
Well, and against this type of offense, they don't need any help. North Carolina State, 24 points with 2 minutes left in the first half. We know they can put points on the board against Clemson last week, one of the best defenses in the country. They put up 27, so they don't need any help.
Well, it's not enough yardage for a first down. The ball comes out to the 25, but they would have been back on about the 8-yard line. Apparently the celebration after the sack went on too long. Now the clock is running under 2 minutes. I think they're taking much more time off the clock before punting, but did not. Bosley Allen in the Wolfpack territory and down at the 47-yard line. 35-yard punt, 14-yard return. 1:47 left in the half.
Bosley Allen, a guy who had a devastating knee injury back in 1998, tore his ACL, MCL, PCL, blood vessels, nerves. One of the best recruited wide receivers since Carl Torbush has been here, and he's been here a long time. Remember, he was the defensive coordinator for Mack Brown long before he became the head coach. Good to have Bosley Allen back and giving North Carolina great field position, because that could have hurt, that penalty could have really tipped the field position towards North Carolina State.
Curry forced to pitch it to Brandon Russell. Nice play by the defense. Corey Lyons up from his linebacker position. Antonio Burnett came to help him. Tar Heels trying to hurry up now with a minute and a half left. And one timeout remaining. Four-man rush. Well picked up. Bailey here to bobble the ball for a moment, but held on for a first down to the 33-yard line. Ryan Williams and Terrence Holt on the tackle. The clock stops as they move the chains after a gain of 15.
And here's a nice job of matchups for North Carolina on offense. You put Corey Bailey out here in the slot. He comes in the middle, and because it's a zone defense, Corey Lyons, the linebacker, has to try to cover the quicker wide receiver.
Curry zings it. Caught. Corey Bailey close to another first down at the 22-yard line. 1:02 left. An 11-yard gain. It is a first down. And they're quickly over the ball. Four wide receivers. Clock runs now. Under a minute remaining in the half. North Carolina State leading by 10. With a 17-point lead moments ago. Curry throws, incomplete. The crowd wanted a flag on Brian Williams for coming over the back of Jamal Jones, but there is no flag.
And the guy that North Carolina has been looking for this entire drive, Corey Bailey, before this game, weren't even sure if he was going to be able to play. The coaches of North Carolina were really stunned when Bailey came out to practice Wednesday and was able to run around as well as he did, but the concern with him is how much you're going to play him. He's usually their punt and kick returner. We have not seen him doing much of that today because you just don't want that hamstring to get any worse with the meat of the schedule coming up.
Three catches today for Bailey. He's one of four wide receivers on the field. Quarterback draw. Curry bounced it outside. Wisely went out of bounds near the 15-yard line. Chased out by Adrian Wilson.
Adrian Wilson, number one, up there chasing around number one Ronald Curry. And this North Carolina State defense was a little tired of a number one last week. Woodrow Dantzler threw for 220 yards, had 103 yards rushing. And Dantzler showed everybody why he is starting to be mentioned for the Heisman. Buddy Green and his defense put up a valiant effort against that hurry-up offense of Clemson. It just wasn't quite enough.
Third down and three. Curry has it batted down by Corey Smith. And the field goal unit comes on.
Boy, if Corey Smith had ever been a tight end, he might have been able to pick that off. That ball was thrown right into his midsection. Didn't really have to jump very high. A cut block on the outside by James Wagstaff, not able to get Corey Smith down. When you run the three-step drop, your offensive tackles have to cut the legs out from the defensive ends or at least get their hands down, because that's exactly the spot where Ronald Curry is throwing it, and that time Wagstaff not able to get Corey Smith off his feet.
NC State called timeout. They didn't have the proper personnel on the field with the field goal unit coming on for Carl Torbush.
Miss distance in Jeff Reed's wheelhouse. He's 6-7. His only miss of 47 yards. This one well inside that.
Time now to answer the Aflac trivia question. We want to know who holds the single game record for passing yards in the series. You said you cheated.
Yeah, and it's a common name in Carolina. At North Carolina.
Other. Jordan. Terry Jordan. That was the last victory for NC State. Dick Sheridan's last year as coach before he retired for health reasons. Jordan went 23 of 25 and throwing for 361 yards. September 26th of 1992.
What happened to those three misses?
Jeff Reed trying a 33-yard field goal. Richard Moore, the holder, is from the right hash mark. Breeze not a factor. And did he hook it enough? Yes, he did. And North Carolina, once down by 17, now within 7 with 34 seconds left in the first half.
Well, Jeff Reed
is 7 out of 8 in field goals now this year.
He's very accurate. As a matter of fact, he is so accurate, he's actually got a better percentage than Jason Capel's free throws from last year.
Jason Cable made 82.9 to be precise. The basketball Tar Heels at Midnight Madness last night. And they had that throughout the triangle here in this area as well. And the other schools, but here at Carmichael on the campus, they had to turn away about 2,000 people ready for Matt Doherty's first year as head coach.
Well, most publications have them in the top five in the preseason. So not only do you have a new coach with great ties to North Carolina, but you're starting out the preseason ranked pretty high. Of course, in this part of the country, you're going to have to turn some folks away.
And Reed will kick off. And the leading return man in the country in kickoff returns is back deep. Horan Robinson, who started the day averaging more than 36 yards per return, lined up behind Julius Patterson.
Horan Robinson, one of those guys that just has that ability every time he touches the ball to do something great. He's averaging nearly 19 yards every time he touches the ball.
Well, with that in mind, they try to avoid kicking it to him, but he's still able to pick it up on the roll at the 15-yard line. They raise it back to the 33. Just one timeout left for the Wolfpack. David Thornton made the tackle on kickoff coverage. 28 seconds left. The ball spotted near the 31-yard line. Let's see how Chuck Amato plays it with a 7-point lead.
Well, I have a feeling with this freshman quarterback, Phillip Rivers, that they're going to play it not close to the vest at all, Sean. This guy, if you want to be impressed with a freshman, if they go into their hurry-up offense, which it looks like they're just going to take a knee and be happy. I'm a little surprised with Chuck Amato, the aggressiveness he has as a coach, that he's taking a knee and going in at halftime with the lead that he has.
North Carolina very nearly had too many men on the field. David Bomar had to run off at the last second. And they will take it to the house. Wide open first half as expected. And Phillip Rivers and the Wolfpack trying to go to 5-1 for the year. With a 24-17 lead over North Carolina. Chuck Amato tries to end the 7-game losing streak for the Pack at the hands of their number one rival. Here's Chip Tarkenton.
Coach, you had a big turnaround there, but talk about the fake punt, the idea that's behind that.
Well, we felt like they had shown that they was going to block four from that side. What they did, take our wing, the guy that we were going to throw it to, and forced him back, so we didn't have a play. Really bad call. I mean, I wish I had it back, but we don't. But at the same time, we're going to be aggressive in this ball game, just like we went forward on fourth down and got to end up getting a touchdown. So it's going to be a ball game, and we're going to have to score some points to win. So what we've got to do is make the plays that we've got an opportunity to make.
Big momentum here at the end of the first half.
No doubt, coming in the way we ended up, should come out the second half with great momentum.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it. Back upstairs.
And I think that first answer is the reason why so many people, including us, admire Carl Torbush. He is a stand-up guy. There's no debating that. Halftime, the Wolfpack with a 7-point lead.
Valvoline, halftime 2000. You can always tell the guys who use Valvoline. From Times Square in New York, John Saunders and Terry Bowden.
High above Times Square Stadium, where we look over everything. College football, Times Square, the ESPN zone, college football fans taking us in and getting plenty for their money down at the zone and playing for your money here, because this has been an unbelievable day right now of college football. Most importantly, you think about the game you're watching right now. 7 consecutive losses to North Carolina by NC State. They're up at halftime.
Yeah, but they've got a great offense. Their offense now is being so good. You've got to look at Chuck Amato as one of these coaches that has a chance to win Coach of the Year. They can score big plays. Phillip Rivers threw for a touchdown pass, ran from him, caught a touchdown pass. They are exciting and explosive. North Carolina has got to come back and win this football game.
All right, the biggest game of the day, though, is in Big 12 country. Kansas State unbeaten. And Bob Stoops in Oklahoma unbeaten. There's Bill Snyder with Stoops. Of course, he was an assistant Stoops for Bill Snyder. And things get going early here. Josh Heupel, 15 yards to Curtis Spagan for the touchdown. Kansas State trailed a couple of times in the first quarter. First time they've trailed, but Jonathan Beasley gets him back.
Yeah, he's been the most exciting quarterback in the Big 12, maybe the country, with his throwing and running for touchdowns. They're number one in the nation in scoring offense, number one in total defense. But you got to wonder if it's against lesser people.
Yeah, he got 100 consecutive passes without the INT before Roy Williams gets him there. Then Quinton Griffin. You want to talk about a touchdown run? Should have been down a couple of times.
Well, this guy got 6 touchdown short runs last week, but he got one long one there. This Josh Heupel and this Oklahoma offense is incredible today against Kansas State.
Now, Kansas State, their schedule early on, quite simply cupcakes for Bill Snyder. We'll point out that Colorado and Kansas are in the Big 12 Conference, but look at what comes in the next 5 games. Here's the question, Terry. The Bowl Championship Series, it hurts them in that because of strength of schedule, but what about preparation? They took a couple bad penalties, a couple of turnovers, and they just don't seem like they're prepared for a tough game.
You got to learn how to play tough, close ball games. When you play all these cupcakes, you blow them out. You don't know how to maintain your poise. We've seen a lack of poise here in the first half. You don't get that by playing these games. Another reason why Kansas State needs to play a tougher non-conference schedule.
They have a second half still to come, but it's going to be tough against that offense of Oklahoma in the SEC. Auburn have lost 5 consecutive games to Florida. As a matter of fact, Terry, you were the last coach to win, and you won there at Florida as well, 35-7. Rex Grossman, 5 touchdown passes. Jabbar Gaffney, 3 touchdown receptions, 10 for the season. That is a freshman record for Florida. Oregon against USC. The Ducks are up 14-7. Joey Harrington, having a great game, said they'll make believers of him this afternoon. They are doing that thus far. UCLA at Cal. Cal got him last year, and they're getting him again.
Well, Cal upset him and shut him out 21-0 last year. UCLA had a week off. They're not playing very well, but got a lot of football left in the second half.
Georgia gets the win against Vanderbilt. It used to be between the hedges. They knocked the hedges down last week. They put some fences up. They still won.
I tell you, Vanderbilt played a better game, outrushed, better football yardage than Georgia, but Georgia wins the game. Quincy Carter, watch that separated shoulder. That's going to be big. He's got Florida 2 weeks from now in the outdoor cocktail bowl.
Yeah, Drew Henson is having his way. 45-0 over Indiana right now. Texas and Colorado. Texas number 23 coming off that big loss to Oklahoma. Have the lead at 13-0. And Grove City against Waynesburg. We show you this one because R.J. Bowers goes 47 carries for 266 yards. That's now 32 consecutive games over 100 yards. That's an NCAA All-Divisions record, breaking the one set by Archie Griffin. Stick around. More to come from Times Square Stadium. We got a close one in the ACC. As he got up, I think I'll paint myself silver and go down to Times Square Stadium to get my way on ABC's college football, and plenty of breakdancing and always action for college football and anything else you like from here in Times Square Stadium. This is Valvoline Halftime 2000. Some of the people out on the streets apparently snuck in and found their way as part of our staff as well. Welcome back, John Saunders and Terry Bowden. Let's get to these scores and the highlights. Remember last year, Penn State was riding high at 9-0. Minnesota came into Happy Valley, and this was one of the last plays of the game. Cockrum throws it up, caught by Arlen Bruce after the tip. It set up a game-winning field goal, and Minnesota knocked Penn State off. They didn't win again in the regular season, the Nittany Lions. So Archie Griffin is on hand today. The Buckeyes had not lost at home to Minnesota since 1949, and Minnesota goes in. Travis Cole going 55 yards to Ron Johnson here, sets up a touchdown.
Yeah, you know, Ohio State had the best defense in the Big Ten, but today it was all Minnesota. They all hold Ohio State to 70 yards rushing.
Tellus Redmond here with a 20-yard touchdown run, takes it in. The two-point conversion was no good. Didn't matter. Minnesota wins it 29-17. Cole, 16 of 28 for 243 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Tellus Redmond had 118 yards on the ground, and you see what Ron Johnson did as well.
Everybody has a loss in the Big Ten now,
including Northwestern as they face Purdue today. Purdue coming off that big victory against Michigan. Drew Brees here, 5 yards to John Standiford. He just watches in with a touchdown. Purdue's up 21-14. Then Brees again to his favorite receiver, Vinny Sutherland.
Well, both these teams can score points, but Northwestern had 3 turnovers in the third quarter, led to 14 points for Purdue.
41-28 is the final. Brees, 22 of 40, 239 yards, and 5 touchdowns. And Mr. Drew Brees for the Heisman. Is he back at the top of your list?
He was my choice at the beginning of the season. He's back.
Yeah, no reason to think anything else right now. Southern Miss is a team, probably the best team you haven't heard about. They are 4-1, had a win over Alabama. Shutout, as a matter of fact. Today facing Tulane, Leo Barnes picks off Ramsey and takes it 30 yards for the touchdown. Southern Miss gets the win. Lou Holtz looking for another victory. Derek Watson, 68 yards in this touchdown run.
But it's their defense that's been doing it. They caused 4 turnovers today. Their defense has led the way for South Carolina.
South Carolina gets another victory. 27-7 is the final on that big reversing run there. Brooks Bollinger knocked out of the game with a concussion for Wisconsin against Michigan State. Jim Sorge, 45 yards to Lee Evans. You see the time remaining, 30 seconds for the touchdown. Wisconsin wins it. Before the game in Orlando, Navy giving a tribute to the sailors who were killed in the USS Cole as they faced Notre Dame. Terrence Coleman fumbles the ball here, recovered by Notre Dame's Tony Driver. He did this twice in the game, 22 yards for this touchdown. As the Irish go on to the victory, 45-14 is the final. And the 37th consecutive victory for the Fighting Irish over Navy, that is number one in Division 1A streaks. As most of you know, Beano Cook loves everything about college football, especially the contact. But apparently there's one form of contact Beano doesn't like. He explains as he takes us out of bounds.
History has failed to record the first time two college football coaches met at midfield after a game to shake hands. They still do it in most games. And to tell the truth, a lot of coaches don't like it, but they won't admit it. It's called sportsmanship. The one coach who says, I don't like it, is Steve Spurrier, Florida. He would tell you he doesn't like to shake hands after a football game, win or lose. Look, in the Battle of Waterloo, do you really think the Duke of Wellington and Napoleon met at midfield with all those dead bodies, people losing legs and shaking hands, and Napoleon saying to the Duke, it was a tough battle, but you deserve to win. And the Duke saying, I looked at the films from Moscow. I knew where you were weak. And let me ask you a question. Do you think if General Patton were a football coach after he lost the football game, especially the Navy, he would go to midfield to shake hands? No way. Maybe it's a thing to do, but you want to know something? I kind of agree with Steve Spurrier. If I were a football coach and I lost the game, I don't think I would want to shake hands. That's just the way I am.
Doesn't want to shake hands. You had some success against Steve Spurrier 6 years you coached against him in 94, won a game in the Swamp. Is that what it's like trying to shake hands with him?
He does not like to shake hands, but you know what? There are not many coaches that like to shake hands with Steve Spurrier either. But you know what? There's a lot of things in life we don't like to do. We still do it because it's the right thing to do. This is about sportsmanship. And it's the right thing to do.
By the way, that's as fast as I've seen you run in the entire time I've known you, just trying to get out of the Swamp. Want to remind you what we have coming next week, 3:30 Eastern time on ABC. Some in the Big Ten will see Michigan State against number 17 Michigan. In the ACC, Virginia against high-flying Florida State, they're number 7. In the Pac-10, it's USC against Stanford, the Rose Bowl, so very much up for grabs. In the Big 12, watch for local listings in your area. Check ESPN.com. Terry Bowden returns in a moment after he shows these guys a little action out of Times Square Stadium. There's more to come in a moment.
Valvoline, halftime 2000. You can always tell the guys who use Valvoline.
We find a defendant guilty.
Sunday.
What a mess. This time they tied her.
A lot of teams around the nation looking like they had calves coming at them all day long here in college football. Welcome back to Times Square Stadium. John Saunders and Terry Bowden. It's time now for the Burger King Spotlight. This week, we highlight LaDainian Tomlinson, the man who led the nation in rushing a year ago.
I'm the workhorse back. I would say I'm a thoroughbred, and I just feel like sometimes I want to get the team on my back and tell them, let's go, baby. Let's go to the end zone.
LaDainian's skills were evident in first grade. On his very first snap, he ran for a touchdown. Today, he runs the 40 in 4.3, benches 430 pounds, squats 600, and he leads the nation in rushing with 194 yards per game.
He says he could do it 2 years in a row. Not too many guys who would lead the nation in rushing the next year wouldn't be one of the favorites for the Heisman, but that's the way it's been. It remains to be seen. Right now, we're going to throw you back out to your game.
And back here in Chapel Hill, the marching Tar Heels on the field. ABC Sports presentation of college football returned after this message and a word from our ABC stations. At halftime, North Carolina State has a 7-point lead over North Carolina. Obviously, the fake punt, a big play in that first half, Ed, and give Carl Torbush credit for standing up. It was his decision, but also give his team credit for digging out of that hole it put him in.
Things looked awful bad. You mentioned body language. They couldn't make any plays. Offense was just kind of out there meandering around. Defense went out, made a big stop, gave their offense a chance. They only had one timeout, so they had to go down and kick the field goal. But the momentum definitely came back for them going into their locker room.
And North Carolina State trying to get the momentum back. They'll receive the second half kickoff. Robinson back for the kickoff from Jeff Reed. Robinson had to catch it backing up into the end zone, so he'll take a knee. Here's Chip.
Coach Amato told his team what he's told them all year long at halftime. He said, just finish. We get the ball first. Let's finish. Go down the field, put points on the board, and get back in this thing, get the momentum back on our side of the field.
Kind of a strange position, Chip, for this team to be in. They've only led at halftime in one other game. That was against SMU. He came in, he started the slogan, finish, but then he had to change it to start and finish because they had been behind so often in the first half.
On the 20, Rivers might be changing the play. He was 7 out of 12 in the first half. A touchdown and an interception. Ray Robinson rips through with a first down. Well, to the 34-yard line, that gets Robinson up to 99 yards rushing for the game. Let's take a look at the Morgan Stanley Dean Witter first half stats. They reflect how even the first half was. The total yards almost dead even.
And for UNC, Mike O'Kane talked about trying to at least get somewhere near 50-50. Well, they flopped it the other way, 135-67. Time of possession for North Carolina, though, 18:04. North Carolina State was in a bit of the hurry-up offense in that first half, but State's defense on the field a ton.
Ray Robinson fighting for extra yardage before he was tackled by Ryan Sim at the 38-yard line, a gain of 4. Sim's a junior from Spartanburg, South Carolina. Quarterback. quarterback as a freshman and sophomore in high school before the fact that he was blossoming up near the current 285 pounds.
Yeah, I got two words for you, training table. That got him out of that quarterback position.
6'4", 285 now. On second and six, they stick with Robinson on the run. He's short of a first down at the 41. They'll need a short three on third down to pick up a first down. Julius Peppers on the bottom of the pile.
Julius Peppers, one of those guys with all kinds of potential. Ken Browning, the defensive coordinator, also the defensive line coach, said, you know, he's starting to learn how to use his hands. A basketball player who misses spring ball with playing basketball, he might use that one time to go through an entire offseason program.
On third and three, Rivers in trouble, and he is finally sacked by Cedric Hodge. You never count Rivers down and out until he is down and out. And finally, Hodge able to swing him down for a 19-yard loss.
You had a second of doubt, though, didn't you, Sean? This guy, I tell you, Cedric Hodge, two great stories. Hodge, a senior, he's been a consistent player, coming on the outside on a blitz. A naked boot, he has left unblocked on purpose, but it took him forever to get the 6'5", 220-pound freshman down.
Austin Herbert with a short wobbly punt and a fair catch made by Bosley Allen at the 47-yard line. Just a 32-yard punt. In this game of considerable momentum shifts, the Tar Heels with momentum still on their side after the big sack.
And all of a sudden, the story of field position that we showed at the halftime stats, the first half, North Carolina State started out at about midfield, their own 44. North Carolina averaged the 25-yard line. Now catching a big break, starting on their own 47.
Now the shotgun, Curry. Three wide receivers in the game, going for the tight end, and it is caught! LG Crumpler with the catch in traffic. The ball was a little late getting there. And Crumpler was still able to pluck it away from the defender to the 20-yard line. 33 yards, Brian Williams nearly had the INT.
And Algie Crumpler is a guy that they've had to do some things on offense to get him the ball. He is such a threat. Blew out his knee back in 98, and what a fantastic job going up with Brian Williams and literally taking the ball away from him. But Crumpler, Michael Kane, has had to do a bunch of things because teams respect 6'3", 260 pounds. What an athlete to go up and make that play.
His first catch of the ball game. This is ninth of the year. And Curry called a timeout with the play clock about to expire. We talk about the little mistakes the Tar Heels make, and there's another problem with time management.
We invite you to check out the great food selection during today's game.
Back in Chapel Hill. The pitch to Brandon Russell. Inside the 15 and down to the 14.
Antonio Burnett had the tackle, Thunder Dan. Last week against Clemson, he had a bum ankle that he had hurt against Georgia Tech. He was only able to walk through basically practice coming up to the 2 weeks following up to Clemson. Now looks like that ankle's 100%. A good job tracking that ball from inside out, the middle linebacker. Such a big force on the option. He's got to get there after the ball is pitched.
Second and four. Carolina hoping for the tying touchdown. First man through, the fullback, Anthony Saunders. And he has the first down to the 9-yard line.
Saunders, a guy who's used to carrying the ball for North Carolina back in 99. He started four games at tailback, had a 110-yard rushing game, his career best against Georgia Tech. Finished the year with close to 300 yards and rushing touchdown as a tailback, and then had some injuries that slowed him.
First and goal from the 9. Willie Parker comes into the backfield now as Saunders came off. Parker's number 15. Curry throws incomplete. Looking for Willie Parker in the flat, and a late flag thrown.
It looked like a pick might have been thrown by Bosley Allen. Now, it's a roughing the passer against North Carolina State. These penalties are things that are hurting North Carolina State. Chuck Amato last week against Clemson, they had these penalties the entire first half, kept some
personal
drives.
Foul, roughing the passer against the defense.
Well, how do you not pull off?
For the goal,
Darius Bryant coming in that late. Not that big of a hit, but the ball had been gone for 2 to 3 seconds. You just have to be smarter when you're going in against the quarterback like that. Just way too late.
First and goal from the 5. Russell right into the pile for a yard. It'll be second and goal from the 4. Join us late. North Carolina State once had a 17-point lead at 24-7. Now it's the Tar Heels driving for what they hope will be the tying score 4 minutes into the second half. Stay with a tight formation. 3 back behind Curry. Russell again. No gain. Outstanding defense by NC State. Corey Smith in on the play.
What a nice job by North Carolina State last week against Clemson. They had some missed tackles on Travis Zachary, who ended up going for 147 yards. But with a young defense, inexperienced defense, Donnie Green and the rest of his staff working very hard in fundamentals, had a couple of weeks off, working on tackling drills, trying to do everything they could in fundamentals.
2 tight ends, 1 wide receiver. It's Bosley Allen, who did not catch it. Incomplete pass. James Walker, the freshman, had the coverage. They were with 2 tight ends, 2 backs, and just the 1 wide receiver, Allen, and tried to throw it to him on the fade. And Allen could not hang on.
Pretty good throw here by Ronald Curry. Allen comes back to the ball. And that's that freshman out there running one-on-one, James Walker, who's replacing J.J. Washington. Pretty good coverage by him getting that left hand out and knocking the ball away.
Well, now they'll try a 21-yard field goal from Jeff Reed from a tough angle from the right hash mark. And he just did sneak it through. A first and goal at the 5, and the Tar Heels settle for the field goal, and they're down by 4 early in the third quarter. Sean McDonough, Ed Cunningham, Chip Tarkenton back in Chapel Hill. And the 90th renewal of this great rivalry between North Carolina State and North Carolina. And the Tar Heels, once down by 17, now trailed by 4.
Guy needs a trim. How does he see?
Here's Jeff Reed to kick it off. And Wolfpack hoping it'll come down in the hands of Corin Robinson. And it will, but perhaps too deep to run it out. He thought about it. And it took a knee. A beautiful facility, Ed, is it not? We saw yesterday the coach's offices here, and that's as nice as any football building we've seen around the country.
And Coach Torbush made no buts about it that when we walked in, he said, yeah, Mac Brown knows how to design an office. He gave all credit to Coach Brown, who left here a great legacy and unbelievable facilities.
And they're about to upgrade the facilities considerably in Raleigh as well for the Wolfpack. Rivers throws, incomplete. Errol Hood ran right over Corin Robinson, but the ball was thrown out of bounds. Did not appear to be catchable. And Hood actually going for the ball. But he took a route right through Corin Robinson to go after that ball.
Robinson having a quiet day receiving the ball. Only 1 catch so far. Running the little out and up. I guess they're saying that ball was uncatchable. It was quite a bit outside, but if that ball had even been close by Rivers, I don't know how.
Well, Hood was going for the ball, and Robinson didn't see it coming. Well, he's entitled to go
going
for the ball
through
as well.
Yeah.
Now the gun, 2nd and 10. Rivers steps up, throws that little flip ahead to Corin Robinson. Out of bounds, perhaps by the face mask, at the 47-yard line of North Carolina. Well, just when you said last week, Robinson was having a quiet receiving day against Clemson, he started piling up the catches, and here he is right on cue for 33.
And it's deja vu all over again for Phillip Rivers, who takes a shot from Brandon Spoon right at the end. A good stiff arm, Devontae Coleman. He got just a tiny little bit of that face mask.
5 yards from the end of the run against the defense. First down.
Sean, it didn't look like he grabbed it. As long as you don't grab a hold of it, I don't understand that call. I mean, he barely got a hold of it. A great stiff arm. Corn Robinson, a rangy guy at 6'3" with very long arms. Now, from that angle, his head did move a little bit back to the inside. So, if you're going to call it, call the 5 yard and not the 15.
The ball now at the 42-yard line, under 10 minutes left, third quarter. Rivers, the quick slant, thrown behind Willie Wright. Let's get an update from John Saunders in Times Square Stadium.
Well, Sean, if people didn't believe last week against Texas, they believe this week of Josh Heupel and Oklahoma. Antoine Savage should have been tackled once, twice, three, four, five times, but he breaks all of them, goes 74 yards for the touchdown, and Oklahoma at K-State leading it 38-14. Sean.
Backing up last week's amazing performance against Texas with another in Manhattan. Rivers dancing around. Look, he was trying to change the play. Could not, and he burns the timeout. So each team has used one here in the opening moments of the third quarter.
And the frustration, Phillip Rivers goes over. He wants to get right on the headset and talk to Norm Chow. Some confusion. You start to see a little bit of anger. It's amazing because Norm Chow says he's worked so hard with this guy. He had him all spring. He said, in a couple of years, I'm going to be able to just roll the ball out there and let him do everything. They're almost to that point right now.
Well, it certainly is evident that Phillip has benefited greatly from being the son of a coach. His dad, Steve Rivers, 28 years a high school coach. He's a very mature young man anyway, but a lot of his football knowledge comes from his dad.
And I love the fact that Steve Rivers, who moved his family up to Raleigh, North Carolina, became a high school coach up in Raleigh. He does not want to be that involved. He meets with him about once a week, and both the Rivers, Phillip and his dad, talk about they stay out of each other's way. Phillip's a freshman in college. He wants to have a little bit of a life, and they kind of stay separated quite a bit, but it's nice to have that support system there.
And Steve Rivers, the dad, can relate to what Michael Cain's going through. Steve coached at Decatur High in Alabama for 22 years and then switched and went down the road 15 minutes to Athens, the arch rival of Decatur, and coached against Decatur. And Coach Phillip at Athens. Coach Rivers said he had tears in his eyes last week at Clemson when he saw his son ride out on the field in that great environment, realizing that Phillip had fulfilled his dream to play major college football in that kind of a setting. Second down and 10.
Put on quite a show in that setting as well.
The pump fake. And now the deep ball for Corn Robinson, and it is batted down by Errol Hood. The ball perhaps just a little bit underthrown. There's a flag down back at the line of scrimmage. And it's a holding call against the Wolfpack. And a decision for Carl Torborst. Does he want it third and 10 at the 42? Or second and longer out beyond midfield?
Well, with this offense, Sean, it's pick your poison.
You want to take the penalty.
Do you want to give him two shots to go 20 or one shot to go 10? That's a lose-lose situation against the Wolfpack.
Holding by the offense, 10 yards, previous spot, repeat second down.
And it might be two plays to get the 10 if you don't take the penalty, because we saw Chuck Amato go for it in this type of field position in the first half.
Absolutely, but what a nice play by Errol Hood to break that up. I thought we had a touchdown here. Corn Robinson looked like he got behind Hood. The ball slightly underthrown by Phillip Rivers. But he was involved in that tackle on the one-foot line last year in Charlotte that got Chuck Amato the job at NC State, basically.
Second and 20. Rivers with another flag down. Corn Robinson has plenty of running room. all the way down to the 26-yard line. But there is a flag thrown by the official on the far sideline right as the ball was snapped. Monte Coleman finally banged Robinson out of bounds. If it stays, it's a 26-yard pickup. If it goes, it's going to be second and even longer. And it's going to come back. The number of penalties in this conference continues to be eye-popping. Seven penalties now against the Wolfpack, five against the Tar Heels. Those are just the accepted penalties today. And there's still more than a quarter and a half to be played.
Illegal motion by the offense. The man in motion moving forward. That's a snap. 5 yards, repeat the down.
That's okay in Canada, but not here.
The Arena Football League allows it now. Top of your screen, the man in motion as he comes to square. He got a little jumpy. Good call by the officials. It looked to be Eric Leek who was the man in motion as he turned to square. You can turn and face the line of scrimmage. You just can't start that little creep up.
Now second and 25. A very big play negated. Blitz brought by the Tar Heels. And another man wide open. Derek Roberts, the fullback. Good tackle in the open field by David Bomar at the 43-yard line. That tackle saved a much longer gain for Roberts. It's a 14-yard pickup.
Well, and here's where an all-out blitz hurts you. North Carolina's kind of been a little bit of everything. Here's a look at Roberts. All the linebackers are coming. Nobody goes. And with the tight end, Willie Wright in there in the mix, running down the seam. Here's Wright right here. Coming back trying to get a block. There was confusion among who would pick up Roberts out of the backfield. And this guy, Phillip Rivers, really moves the ball around. Over 100 yards receiving for the fullback.
Third down and 11. Rivers sidestepped one rusher and then got buried by Ryan Sims.
Ken Browning, the defensive coordinator for North Carolina and also the defensive tackles coach for the last 7 years. This is his first year as the defensive coordinator taking over for Coolbuck. Says this guy is as good as some of the other ones they've had, a bunch of first-rounders, Bonnie Holiday, one of them.
Herbert's punt bounces into the end zone. With the 50-yard punt, just a net of 30, if the ball will come out to the 20-yard line. College football on ABC Sports, brought to you by Mazda. Mazda, get in, be moved. By Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, move your money, get well connected. A National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. In by Pacific Life. Annuities, insurance investments, use the power of Pacific Life.
Both of these teams kind of trading mistakes back and forth, and there a couple of penalties hurts NC State as they get to midfield, and now North Carolina, that momentum we talked about, is really starting to shift in their direction.
Razzle dazzle again, and buried is Bosley Allen. Corey Smith and LeVar Fisher in the backfield. Drop that play back at the 12-yard line, a loss of 8.
Well, when you have to defend the reverse, it's like playing the option. It's all about assignment football. Corey Smith, the defensive end, does an excellent job. The backside defensive end's job on a reverse is to be as deep as the football. And Buddy Green, the defensive coordinator, says that Corey Smith, both assignment-wise and performance, is his most consistent player.
Second and 18. Pass in the flat and slipping down is Brandon Russell. Gain of a yard on the play. We're at Kenan Stadium in Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Sold out, 60,000 on hand. 5,000 tickets allotted to NC State, but many more Wolfpack fans here who bought tickets that weren't part of the allotment. John McDonough, Ed Cunningham, Chip Tarkenton. This has been what we've expected. Lots of offense. The team's moving up and down the field. Big plays on each side. Third and 16 now for the Tar Heels. Runs trail 24-7. Curry too far to run. Brian Jameson takes him down after a gain to the 16-yard line. Jamison, a reserve defensive end, but it seems like he makes as many big plays as anybody on Coach Amato's defense.
He's the guy with a lot of speed from that defensive end spot, his third sack on the season, and you don't get any breaks for the Wolfpack. Go right back in and help block for the punt return.
John Lafferty got the punt off, and then he got hit, and another flag thrown as Dexter Reed took down Corin Robinson. Looked like Reed didn't give Robinson the two-yard radius to which he's entitled to make the catch. There's going to be a flag on each side. But is it 5 or 15 for hitting the kicker?
It was an awfully hard hit, Sean. I believe they, from what it looked like up here, it's going to be the 15-yarder. NC State, who has 5 block kicks on the year, 4 block punts, coming all out. A little bit of a fake there. That was a leg drag by Brian Williams. It looked like Eric Leek got down there, but...
We have a personal foul, roughing a kicker against the defense. We have a halo violation of kick-catching interference by the offense. The foul's offset. We'll replay the down.
Well, we talk about the costly mistakes the Tar Heels make over and over again. There's another one. They would have had a first down on the roughing the kicker, and instead they have to punt again.
And in college football, you're drilled time and time again that there is no reason to go for the big hit, because going for that big hit, you're going to be inside the two-yard radius. You're going to get the call.
And why that was a 15-yarder anyway is...
that's a good question.
Lafferty with not as much of a rush this time. Hangs up a high punt. Robinson with his two-yard radius intact. Makes a fair catch at the 47-yard line. 38-yard punt by John Lafferty. Back in Chapel Hill, North Carolina State, gone stagnant on offense. The Wolfpack still in possession of a 4-point lead with 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Excellent field position for NC State. Rivers has to get rid of it quickly, and it's batted down. Incomplete. Joey Evans, a reserve defensive end, number 95, knocked it down. Down the sidelines, here's Chip.
Well, guys, they've definitely made a change with the North Carolina defense. You can see it. What's taking place is they are coming after Rivers right now. They have decided they are not going to lay back. They're going to let their cornerbacks and safeties make plays, and they're going to come after Rivers. And you can see they're bringing everybody that they can, just like y'all were talking about. That's exactly what they're going to do.
And what a great adjustment it has been. 4 of the first 5 possessions for North Carolina State, they scored. They have not scored on their last 4 possessions.
But part of it was very good field position, their first 2 possessions. The fake punt put them up against it. That's a catch and a fumble by Brian Peterson. Tar Heels say they have it at the 37-yard line. That was ruled a catch and a fumble. Oh, now an incomplete pass. How is it an incomplete pass after you go into the pile to see who has the ball? Why would you need to go into the pile and take 20 seconds and then rule it incomplete? And they're still talking about it. They never ruled it incomplete until the referee, Jack Childress, went into the pile, came out, and said incomplete pass. There's no need to go into the pile if that's not a catch and a fumble. And there was no signal like that until the pile up and the players battling for position and possession of the ball. Was a good call, as we can see there. It didn't look like he ever had the ball.
But John, why isn't a whistle blown earlier than that?
Yeah, there was no whistle and no signal.
So guys dive into a pile to get that ball.
Yep. They made the right call in the final analysis, but it was more than a little bit late. Third down and 10. Rivers under that pressure again and sacked. Back of the 35, Joey Evans, the junior from Fayetteville, North Carolina, with a couple of big plays in that sequence.
You know, Chip talked about the change that this defense has made, decided to come after Ken Browning. When we met with him a couple of weeks ago before that Georgia Tech game, he talked about our defense doesn't have an identity yet. I don't know what my guys can do. Can we play zone? Can we blitz? Can we come after them? Well, they're developing an identity this afternoon coming up. No blitz there, just great rush from the outside.
Nose up spiral punt. from Austin Herbert. Bosley Allen trying to find some running room, and he cannot. LeVar Fisher among those down on punt coverage. Corey Lyons also there. The starters, many of them out there on punt coverage for the Wolfpack. Last year, as we bring you our Courtyard by Marriott moment, we flash back to this meeting between these two great rivals. November 11th in Charlotte. North Carolina leading 10-6 in the closing moments. There's the tackle by David Bomar that stopped NC State's Chris Coleman shy of the end zone to preserve the win. There's David's dad, Gail Bomar, and his mother, Margie. Gail Bomar was a terrific quarterback here in the late 60s, and as you might be able to tell from the get-up, an avid fan of the Heels, and particularly his son, number 42, who likely saved Carl Torbush's job. And David Bomar came here as a walk-on. He was rewarded with a scholarship. Wasn't really recruited by any school, big or small, out of high school. It was always his dream to come here to follow in his dad's footsteps. Walked on, nearly gave it up a couple of times, stayed, earned a scholarship, and perhaps saved his coach's job last year. On second down, Russell lunges to the 41. A yard short of the first down. Gail Bomar in the late 60s had a couple seasons when he led them in everything. Passing, rushing, total offense. He was a dual-threaded quarterback on those Tar Heel teams of the late 60s.
And it's interesting because now you start to see that come back in vogue with the quarterbacks now in college football starting to lead both in rushing and passing. We saw Woody Dantzler last week. Michael Vick put on a show Thursday night on ESPN. Everybody thinks that's new. It was around a long time ago.
Third and short, and Russell has the first down out to the 43-yard line. Needed one and got two. As we go under 4 minutes left in the third quarter.
And it's nice to see North Carolina starting to feed a little bit off of how well their defense. It's like that attitude of defense that North Carolina is playing in this second half, bringing the heat, they're making the tackles, making big plays in the backfield of North Carolina State. You start to see it in the body language of the offense. When I used to play on the offensive line, whenever a big play was made on defense, you're over there on the sideline getting jacked up to go back on the field.
Take the handoff out of the gun. Curry going deep, looking for Bosley Allen. Incomplete. Flag down for a pass interference call against the true freshman, James Walker. If you joined us late, Walker's in there because the starter at that corner, J.J. Washington, left in the first half with a torn ACL.
Also mentioned Quentin Allen is out with a torn calf. Good coverage, the left hand, no question, of Walker gets up in there. He had good coverage, but it was the left hand that brought down the right arm of Bosley Allen and stopped the chance of him catching the ball.
Pass interference by the defense, 15 yards, automatic first down.
And Sean, last week against Clemson, North Carolina State had 104 yards of penalties. And in Death Valley, even though they put up 402 yards of total offense against the best defense in the country, too many mistakes down there, and it's starting to make them pay here in the second half against North Carolina.
Walk off from the line of scrimmage, 15 yards to the 41-yard line of North Carolina State. First and 10, Tar Heel. Were the only points of this quarter on a field goal, and they first and goal at the 5 and settled for 3 instead of the game-tying touchdown. Darius Bryant took down Curry. He kept it on the option. Bryant's a junior in Suffolk, Virginia. Back up last year after starting in 98. He's back in the starting lineup this year.
And he's one of those guys that Coach Stroud, the strength and conditioning coach brought up from Florida State by Chuck Amato, worked with, worked out. He lost 23 pounds. He's still 282, so not a small fellow, but he was awfully big when Chuck Amato got here.
Second and 7. The fullback, Anthony Saunders, the junior from Greensboro. To the 36, Jeff Fisher pulled him down. Monday night, this has developed into one of the great rivalries in the NFL. Jacksonville and Tennessee, live at 9 Eastern as Steve McNair and the Titans try to beat the Jags for the fifth straight meeting.
What a rematch of last year's AFC Championship game in Tennessee, a beautiful game. Got the chance to actually be there in Washington. all the way down to the end. Hope for another one Monday night.
Four wide receivers as Curry goes out of the gun on third down and five. He's in trouble. Gets away for a moment. Now he's sacked. Back at the 47-yard line, Brian Jameson and Corey Smith combined on a 12-yard sack.
Well, we saw an amazing effort last week at Clemson by LeVar Fisher. We're seeing another one today. Watch on the outside. Corey Smith just gets a great rush up the middle. Never gives up on the play. Bounces back up, and he's going to get a half a sack with Jameson. That's incredible effort by the junior out of Richmond, Virginia. Wow, what a nice job bouncing back up after he got pushed by the quarterback.
Lafferty to punt. Hangs it up. And Corin Robinson makes the fair catch at the 17-yard line. So it's developing into a defensive struggle now. Sharp contrast to the first half. Tomorrow, the Indy League Racing travels to Texas Motor Speedway for the last race of the season. And the championship is on the line. Buddy Lazier, Scott Goodyear, and Eddie Cheever are all still in the running for the Northern Light Cup. That's tomorrow at 4 Eastern right here on ABC Sports.
Kane over there meeting with Brandon Russell and Ronald Curry. You mentioned how he enjoys being back in with the guys. That's the one thing as a head coach you miss. You don't get to work with the guys.
Nice bounce to the outside by Ray Robinson, and he's out to the 26-yard line. Chopped down by Errol Hood. 114 yards rushing now and 21 carries for Ray Robinson. The ACC Rookie of the Year in 98. They're going to have the Rookie of the Year for the third straight year.
Yes, they are.
Robinson 2 years ago. Corin Robinson last year. And if Phillip Rivers doesn't win it, there'll be an investigation this year. Ball loose. Ray Robinson fumbled. And the Wolfpack got it back close to the first down marker at the 28. Looked like Corin Robinson was near the football as it was on the ground.
Has this guy done enough today? He's covered punts. He's returned punts. He's blocked downfield. He's been a decoy on reverses for thrown touchdowns by Brian Peterson. He's done everything. Now he goes in there scrapping at the bottom of the pile and keeping the possession alive for the Wolfpack. And what a long way Corin Robinson has come as a player. When Chuck Amato first got here, he almost ran him off. And Chuck Amato worked under Lou Holtz while he was at NC State. At NC State, Lou Holtz told him, you can run off some great players, but you'll never run off a winner. And he almost ran off Corin Robinson. Robinson very happy that he stuck around.
Third and inches. In the third quarter, NC State leading by four. And it looks like Rivers got it. Just needed to move forward and a couple of inches, and he got about a yard for a first down for North Carolina State.
You mentioned the lock that NC State has on ACC Rookies of the Year. Well, Phillip Rivers has been named the ACC Rookie of the Week five times. They've given the award six times. Well, that six times they were playing BYE that weekend.
Thrown for a loss. Great penetration by Will Chapman, the sophomore from Lexington, Kentucky, came here as a walk-on. Had scholarship offers to play at Kentucky and at Division I AA Richmond, but wanted to play here because his dad Bill played here for Bill Dooley in the early 70s. And as a walk-on, Chapman has made his mark. End of the third quarter. The defense taking over here in the second half. ABC Sports presentation of college football will return after this message and a word from our local ABC station. Fourth quarter, Phillip Rivers dumps it off, and Ray Robinson's dropped for a loss. Back to the 21-yard line by Brandon Spoon and David Bomar. It'll be third down and long. Ray Robinson grabbing at his right knee. Just 3 points in the third quarter after a wide-open first half on both sides. And it was the first time that NC State did not score in the third quarter this season. The Pack still in possession of a four-point lead.
You mentioned the great year that Ray Robinson had back in 98 as the ACC Rookie of the Year. 99, They expected big things. He was slowed by a bunch of injuries. Had an ankle problem. His right leg gets tangled underneath. A great job by Brandon Spoon, but that leg just got tangled underneath as Spoon landed on top of it. But Ray Robinson also broke an arm and had knee cartilage damage last year. He looks very uncomfortable on that right leg that rolled up under Spoon.
And they don't have a lot of depth at that position. Cotre Jackson comes in. He's had two carries all year. He's a sophomore from Birmingham, Alabama. K.J. Stone has also seen some time at the tailback position. He's been bothered lately by a hip flexor, but he's had just eight rushes all year. Ray Robinson, when they run the ball or throw it to a back, he's pretty well the man. Third down and 18. What has happened to this explosive NC State offense since the middle of the second quarter? It's a four-man rush. Rivers with a lot of time has a man wide open. There's the big play for the Wolfpack. Willie Wright all the way to the 40-yard line of North Carolina. Tar Heels rushed four, and Rivers had all day to pick apart the secondary, and he did for a 41-yard gain.
Well, Sean, you mentioned at the beginning of the game how Ken Browning, the defensive coordinator of North Carolina, says we have matchup problems with Willie Wright. 6'4", 213 pounds. That's not matchup problems. That's a missed assignment.
When you're only rushing four, especially, there's no excuse for somebody running that wide open in the secondary.
Well, you're rushing four so you can get back in that coverage, and the reason he's running so free is Reed got caught up in the wash, and he didn't know if it was Devontae Coleman or himself who should have been covering number 80.
North Carolina State's called another timeout. Assistant head coach Doc Holliday on the state sideline. Carl Torbush talking to his defense.
Right now they're just trying to figure out who had what, when, where. Because that time, a big play by North Carolina State. But that's where Phillip Rivers, as a true freshman, he sees those things. He sees when things are not matched up right. He had a great play last week to Corin Robinson for a 64-yard touchdown that was supposed to be a running play. He saw that he had isolation out of Robinson, made the change. He was very cool under the center.
Well, they're looking at Ray Robinson on the Wolfpack sideline. Football on ABC Sports is brought to you by Chevrolet. If only everything was as dependable as a Chevy. Chevy will be there. By Sears and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy. And by Burger King. Got the urge? Well, we have a moment. We want to send along best wishes to one of our favorite people, Nora Swafford, the wife of ACC Commissioner John Swafford. Nora recovering nicely from recent surgery. We're glad to hear she's doing well, and we send our best wishes along. First and 10 from the 40-yard line of North Carolina. Four wide receivers in for the pack. Quick drop by Rivers. Going for the deep ball. And it's incomplete. Looking for Brian Peterson, who thought he was being held along the far sideline by Michael Waddell, but there is no flag. And there is some smack talk, it seems, from Waddell.
Well, whether that was that interference or not, if that was Maurice Green out there running, I don't think he would have caught up with that ball. It's a little bit uncatchable. Phillip Rivers, who got hit 27 times last week by Clemson, took a shot that time by Julius Peppers, but a better job by this NC State offensive line against a very good North Carolina pass rush today.
Being Clemson, the Tigers just underway at home against Maryland. A big favorite today in Death Valley. Rivers it all day, dumps it over the middle. Roberts tackled in the open field by Cedric Hodge. Short gain to the 37-yard line. It'll be third down. Here's Chip.
Well, Sean, what they're saying is that Ray Robinson has a foot injury. It's sprained right now. They're going to ice him down and see if the foot can get back to where he can put pressure on it and run on it. They're going to keep ice on it probably a series or so, see if he can come back. No further damage. It's a foot sprain.
Problem with a foot sprain, though, when you get that ice on there, that thing starts to lock up. If it's tight right now, icing is the right thing to do, but it does make it awfully stiff.
Tar Heels bring the heat on Rivers, and they get to him. Fifth sack of the day. This one from Anthony Perkins.
And that's one thing that North Carolina has done all year long very well. They're first in the ACC. Now they have 30 sacks on the year. They had 10 against Wake Forest. And this time the house was coming, and there was nowhere for the freshman Rivers to get out of the way.
Austin Herbert angling for the far sideline. By Allen making a risky running catch. He made the fair catch at the 18-yard line. Well, even the mascots into it in this heated rivalry. First and 10 Tar Heels from the 18. Pass incomplete. Ori Bailey with the ball behind him couldn't catch it. Again, not a very accurate medium range throw by Curry. Behind the man and really a little softer than it needed to be, Ed.
Well, you hate to keep harping on the problems that Curry has had with those intermediate passes, but for him to step up and go to that next level as a quarterback, he's got to, that's an easy completion. Guys right in front of him, wide open in the middle of the zone. He's got to start hitting those things in numbers.
Well, he's in trouble and taken down by Corey Smith. Instead of a first down out of the 30-yard line, now you're against the down and distance, second and 10. And even more so now, it'll be third down and about 12.
And now North Carolina going to that no huddle, trying to cause confusion and personnel mismatches for North Carolina State.
12 and a half minutes remaining. Out of the gun on third and long. Curry with a lot of time. Throws almost intercepted by LeVar Fisher. Another poor throw by Ronald Curry with plenty of time.
One of the things that was brought to North Carolina State by Chuck Amato was the Fang stickers. He figured he wanted to give his defensive players some little extra credit for making plays, and LeVar Fisher, time and time again, leads the Fang Club every week.
Rafferty got the punt off. It's high and short again. It takes a good bounce for North Carolina State. Back to the 42-yard line of the Tar Heels. Just a 25-yard punt. This is starting to resemble the second half last week when Clemson couldn't put away North Carolina State, but North Carolina State couldn't get the tying score. Same is true in reverse now. It's the Wolfpack with the lead, unable to deliver the knockout punt to Carl Torbush's team, unable to get the equalizer or get ahead, too.
This is something they've gotten used to in this rivalry. The last couple of years, everybody at NC State says, oh, they had no business beating us. We were better. So sometimes it really doesn't matter what happens, and it's just going to kind of be a funny bounce of the ball that might determine who comes out on top.
Still no sign of Ray Robinson. Coach Ray Jackson lined up at tailback. Lots of fakes. Rivers throwing for Tremaine Simmons. He has it down to the 12-yard line. Lindsey Monk was running right with him step for step. But Simmons with great concentration to make the catch. And a first down for the Wolfpack. They'll spot it at the 11-yard line.
Tremaine Simmons lined up as the fullback in the backfield. We saw him earlier in the game line up as a tight end. He's listed as a fullback. He's done a lot of things. We talked about Corin Robinson doing a bunch of different things. Now we start to see Tremaine Simmons, who they used quite a bit in the first half, start to get some life here in the fourth quarter.
Simmons had no rushes or receptions coming into the game. Coach Ray Jackson hammered out of bounds by Defonte Coleman. Out of bounds at the 7-yard line, a 4-yard gain. A big hit by Coleman, who was a wide receiver until he moved to safety in the spring.
And Tremaine Simmons, once again, he has to run down the field for a 20-yard pass and now lines up at the fullback as we look at Ray Robinson. That's not a good sign. The tape is cut off the foot. He's got the ice. Wouldn't be surprised if them shoulder pads are loosened up.
Rotary Jackson, the one back. They have two tight ends in the game. On second down and 6. And the pass is incomplete. Intended for Willie Wright. The ball seemed to catch him by surprise as he turned back toward the ball. And it'll be third down. And this is big. Because obviously at this juncture, huge difference between a touchdown and a field goal. They're in easy field goal range, it appears.
Well, the good news for Doc Holliday and his offense, he's getting the signals from upstairs from Norm Chow, is they can get a first down, get inside that 1-yard line, get a fresh set of downs. So not necessarily having to go for it all.
Now three wide receivers and Jackson alone back. And need to get to the 1 for a first down. Rivers flush from the pocket. Rivers forced to throw it. Incomplete. Ryan Sims was in hot pursuit. And here comes the field goal unit. Trying to put the lead back to 7 for the Wolfpack. Their largest lead was 17. Kent Passingham connected earlier today from 25 yards. We haven't tried any really long ones this year with Passingham. His longest attempt was 35 yards against Indiana, and he made it. This will be another 25-yard try from just inside the left hash mark. Bobby Moore is the holder. And the kick is no good. He hooked it. Wide left. So it's still a 4-point lead for the Wolfpack with 11:43 remaining in Chapel Hill. An injured Tar Heel on the field goal attempt. Julius Peppers being tended to by the North Carolina medical staff.
Julius Peppers is the jumper. He's the basketball player. He goes up and it's like he gets undercut going up for a rebound, and his left arm comes down right on that shoulder, and that's what they're working on right now. But with his jumping ability, here's Peppers right here going up to the point of the ball, undercut there by the offensive lineman and lands right on that left shoulder and on his back. He's up and moving towards the line of scrimmage, but he was down on the turf for a long time, Sean.
Well, that has Carl Torbush and Matt Doherty holding your breath. Yeah. Matt Doherty, the new basketball coach here. Peppers will head for the basketball team when football's over. He was a key component in their surprising run to the Final Four in the NCAA tournament last year. He averaged 6 points a game in the NCAA tournament.
Became the poster boy, too. A couple of shots on the cover of the USA Today sports section.
Officially a 24-yard field goal miss by Passingham. Here's a passing man. Curry! Fumble! Free football recovered by North Carolina State. Shane Riggs knocked it out with a hit from behind. And it looked like Antonio Burnett recovered the fumble.
Shane Riggs coming from the blind side, working one-on-one against Lewis Marchetti, the left tackle. Riggs not even listed in the two deep before this game. Starting to get some players on the field. Chuck Amato knows about building depth. He did that while he was at Florida State. Florida State always played a lot of guys at the defensive front. And Shane Riggs getting his shot today, making the most of it. A huge sack, force fumble combination.
Oh, another chance for the Wolfpack offense to deliver a big blow. Jackson bounces off the tackle of Spoon. Up run by Coach Trey Jackson. Down to the 7-yard line. He got 9. And he ran through their best tackler, Brandon Spoon. Finally, Dante Coates and Defonte Coleman made the tackle.
Brandon Spoon is really the... And there's Rick. What a nice sophomore from Charlotte, North Carolina. You know he's got to have some friends and family here. One of the first times he gets on the field, he gets to go over there and celebrate a huge play.
Second and a yard. Deep handoff. Coach Jackson turns the corner. Touchdown, Wolfpack.
At the point of attack, so nice, as a matter of fact, that Derek Roberts, the fullback, gets to go down and get a great cut block on the middle linebacker, Brandon Spoon, and bad foot and all, Ray Robinson can still see over high enough to know that his backup did the job for him.
Second touchdown of the season for Coach Ray Jackson, and the extra point is up and good from Bobby Moore after the miss by passing him a moment ago. They switched kickers, and Moore, who had been the holder, kick the extra point. Big touchdown by Jackson. It's an 11-point game.
Of 31-20, NC State leads. Derek Roberts, the fullback, senior. He has zero rushing attempts on the year. We got to give him a little bit of love. Watch right here. He helps out on the tight end on Joey Evans. He makes sure he gets the hook block, continues upfield, and gets a great cut block on Brandon Spoon, the middle linebacker, to get Coach Ray Jackson into the end zone. Sean, he doesn't have any rushing attempts, so we got to start pointing out some good things this guy's doing.
And he does a number of them. Austin Herbert will kick off. The lead back to 11 for the Wolfpack. And Aiken, only about 2 yards deep in the end zone, takes a knee. Here's John Saunders in Times Square Stadium.
Sean, time for the Burger King play of the day. It was a 38-14 lead at one point for Oklahoma. They come back with 10 straight. K-State, they blocked this punt. Terrence Newman takes it in for the touchdown, and K-State within a touchdown. And right now, still about 6.5 to go. We'll keep you up to date. Sean, back to you.
All right, John, thank you. Well, that's turned into quite a game, and this has been a good game throughout. NC State once led by 17 in the first half. Now they're in four. Now it's back to an 11-point lead. Russell, a hard-earned 3-yard gain, tackled by Corey Lyons. Here's Chip.
Julius Peppers, we've been working on him. He has a concussion. He will not be back in the game. They say he's extremely woozy on the sideline here, so he is done for the day. That is a big blow to the Carolina defense.
Best defensive end, rush defensive end for Carolina, lands right on his head from about 6 feet up in the air.
And it's a defense that's played very well today for North Carolina. You see 31 points on the board, but there's more to the story. Curry takes off and has a first down up to the 32. That Carolina defense has had to defend the short field all day. On the 4 touchdown drives by the Wolfpack, they had to go only 55, 27, 38, and 15 yards. Only once did they start on their own side of midfield to drive for a touchdown. So that defense has been up against it all day and has done very well for the Tar Heels. Ronald Curry comes out after that play. Apparently, taken up again, and Antoine Black, who was in briefly in the first half, when Curry had the wind knocked out of him, is in on first and 10, and he needs to take the snap. He did with 1 second left. Play action pass, throws, caught by Bosley Allen. Short, low throw, but Allen made the catch. And I think Allen's probably wondering, am I going to see one ball thrown to me today that's right in the number 3? Because it seems like he's had the lunge for everything his way today.
Hey, lay off Antoine Black. He just came in the game. That's
I'm not saying anything about Black. I'm just making the observation.
Absolutely.
Allen's had no easy catches today.
But that's a lot to ask for a guy to come cold off the bench and throw a 20-yard out route. That's awfully tough.
And he did it very well. You happy? First and 10. Pitch to Russell. He got buried at the 49-yard line by guess who? Adrian Wilson, a heat-seeking missile wearing number 1. We're told that Ronald Curry might have lost the contact lens, and that's why he came out of the game.
At the end of the play, there was a lot of, when you're at the bottom of a pile running play, a lot of hands flying around. Finger might have got in there and knocked it out. And
well, that's the problem.
There's no question what he's doing there.
He's in a hurry to get back in there. No sense of urgency on that sideline. He's been a little bit scattershot throwing today. Clock ticking down to 9 minutes left. Black steps into the pocket, running for his life. Gets across the line of scrimmage. And then taken down to the 50. And the officials ruling that he was down. The ball came out. Sean Locklear, the redshirt freshman from Lumberton, North Carolina, made the tackle after a brief gain. It'll be 3rd down and 5.
Locklear, a guy that they really want to get on the field for NC State. The only thing he lacks is experience. He does not lack speed. The fastest inside defensive tackle for Chuck Amato. This guy, true freshman, had a great game against Clemson last week. 5 tackles, 2 for loss, and a sack. He picks up where he left off last week.
Nice bounce back win for Mac Brown's Longhorns at Colorado today after the hammering they took against Oklahoma. Quarterback draw, Black. Some nifty footwork, but he did not get the first down. Needed to reach the 45-yard line. He's about a half yard shy. George Anderson made the critical stop. And this would seem to be four down territory, and it is. Ronald Curry coming back onto the field for the vital fourth down play as the clock runs under 8 minutes remaining in the fourth.
And Sean, you had mentioned when Ronald Curry was putting in his contact lens, it didn't look like he was in any hurry to get in. So what they had to do was take advantage of Antoine Blackbeat and their very athletic quarterback and run two quarterback runs.
Hand it off to Russell, first down. Fighting for the extra yardage down to the 41-yard line. Brian Williams made the tackle. 94 yards rushing now for the true freshman Brandon Russell. His career high in this, the sixth game of his college career.
And the one thing that is really evident, we've talked about it the entire game. We said there was guys on NC State's defense against Clemson who had to play 110 snaps. When you included the defensive snaps they had to play, these guys play hard from start to finish, and it's the same guys out there the entire game.
Tar Heels on the move. Time is starting to work against them. Curry sacked again by Brian Jameson. Back at the 47-yard line.
Well, Brian Jameson is an awfully fast defensive lineman. He's also an awfully strong defensive lineman. Watch the bull rush that he puts on Marchetti. The inside hand, great leverage over the top, makes the sack.
Now Curry had to retreat as he threw under pressure. And the pass short intended for Jamal Jones. He had to throw it off his back foot. Brian Jameson in there again, and Corey Smith.
Both of those defensive ends have played fantastic for North Carolina State today, getting pressure. That was a long throw for Ronald Curry. He was not able to set his feet because of the rush of Corey Smith and Brian Jameson.
Third down and 16. An 11-point lead for North Carolina State. They've lost the last seven against North Carolina. Curry. Running out of time. By some time. Throws it long, too long for Bosley Allen. James Walker had the coverage. Corey Smith was chasing Curry around. And apparently too much time left for Coach Torbush to go for this fourth down long. Fourth and 15. Actually 16. Well, we know they have a fake in. John Lafferty to punt. And this is the best contact he's made at a time where he didn't want to kick it quite that well. In the end zone for a touchback. A 47-yard punt, but a net of 27. And we'll return to Chapel Hill right after this. Gorgeous sunset to the west of this beautiful campus, University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. NC State try to run some time off the clock with an 11-point lead at 6.5 minutes remaining. Mostrey Jackson, the ball carrier, short game. Brandon Spoon upended him. At the conclusion of this game, we will select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
There's a shot at Doc Holliday, the former coach at West Virginia. Has not an FSU connection, but he played for Bobby Bowden at West Virginia.
West Virginia, 22 years. You mentioned $1 million staff. They have 7 assistant coaches making more than $100,000. That's a lot of money in any business, particularly in this business. Andre Jackson out to the 29. David Bomar made the tackle, a yard short of the first down. And it's good to see assistant coaches start to get paid that kind of money. There's a lot of money in this sport. These are the guys who put in incredible hours, make unbelievable sacrifices away from their family while coaching and recruiting, and they should be compensated.
And any head coach who's worth his weight in salt will tell you that, you know what, the head coach sometimes can end up being a figurehead. It's these guys that coach the guys on a day-to-day basis and really provide what you need out on the field.
Big play here. Third down and one. Jackson stopped short of the first down. Now don't blame the Tar Heel defense if you're a Tar Heel fan today. This bunch has played well. The offense and special teams have put them in some tough spots. Well, they had to go three downs and out there, and they forced the punt.
Nice job up the middle. Take a look at Ross McAllister, one of the backup defensive linemen. Also on the bottom of that pile was Anthony Perkins, a.k.a. not Psycho, full tilt. Not from his pinball game, it's because he goes full tilt all the time.
Austin Herbert to punt. Bosley Allen standing at the 35-yard line. Did they jump offside?
Wow.
Amazing if they did. Well, we've talked all day about the seemingly endless line of mistakes made by the Tar Heels, and the one thing they absolutely could not do is jump offside.
Head ball foul, offside by the defense, 5 yards, first down.
Center looked up.
Well, and you know, Sean, the one thing about a center, as a snapper, I used to deep snap. You do that to try to get them to draw offsides. But if the official deems that that was done to draw them offsides, they can call illegal motion on the offense. I'm not so sure that the center from North Carolina State didn't get away with one there.
Still, you can't jump offsides. Danny Young, the snapper, credit him with the heads-up play. There's Brandon Spoons making the tackle, but they can't afford the Tar Heels to have this much time run off the clock. They need to get the ball back right there where they had the chance. They have two timeouts left. 4 minutes remaining. Ken Browning's defense has been terrific. And today, a lot of special teams mistakes. The 48-yard line. Darrell Hood, Defonte Coleman made the tackle, and on that Wolfpack sideline, they can start to taste their first victory in this rivalry since 1992.
A great job by the right guard, Reggie Poole, knocking his man clear out of the middle, but Cotre Jackson gets that left arm on the ball. There's no way he's going to fumble that thing away.
Across midfield, and will the Tar Heels start to use their timeouts with 3 minutes to go? Not now. If time permits, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental post-game report, the scores and highlights from across the country with John and Terry. That's if time permits.
Well, Sean, that clock is starting to tick away. They're in a tough spot over on North Carolina sideline. They've already burned one of those timeouts because of mismanagement on offense. But you got to start thinking about getting rid of the other two. Don't keep them in your hip pocket.
Okay, Jackson picks up the first down. And whether it's fair or not, Ed, the critics of Carl Torbush, who've been calling for his head, are going to point to all these little things that would indicate they're an undisciplined team and use it against him. I don't know if that's fair or not. I mean, the players should know better. They've been coached throughout their lives not to jump offside on a punt play like that. When they continue to make mistakes like that over and over again, sometimes you wonder how much the coaching factors in.
Well, and people are already looking for a reason to build a bonfire under Carl Torbush. And you're right, Sean. Those things start to become logs on that fire.
Jackson might take it to the house. One man to beat. And Hood slowed him down just long enough for Dexter Reed to save the touchdown. But that's probably a moot point now. First and goal for the Wolfpack. After a 37-yard run, Coach Ray Jackson saying, hey, let me play a little more off the coast.
Well, when he came into the game, Sean, as Ray Robinson went by him, his jersey was all dirty and green with grass stains. And Coach Ray Jackson looked like he just came from the launderer. Well, now he's got to get tackled a few times so he can get on that bus and feel good about playing today.
There you go. 91 yards rushing now. He didn't have a carry in the first half. He's at 11 here in the second half after Ray Robinson got injured. Jackson stood up and driven back by Quincy Monk and Defonte Coleman. Under a minute and a half remaining.
Rushes for 3 yards. was what Coach Ray Jackson had coming into today's game. I mean, that's stepping up. Ray Robinson is the man in the backfield for North Carolina State. Coach Ray has to come in. Robinson sprains his foot. Finally gets that jersey a little bit dirty to go home proud.
Rivers with a deep handoff. Jackson, touchdown. No one more score for good measure. And the celebration begins in earnest on that North Carolina State sideline. They're about to win for the first time against their arch rival since 1992.
Chukwumato had a great quote when we were talking to him the other day. When he got hired as a North Carolina State head coach, they hadn't beat North Carolina in seven straight ties, and they said, if you're going to win one game a year, make it against North Carolina. He said, so if I'm 5-50 after 5 years, do I get to keep my job?
I think they'd rather be 50-5 with five losses to North Carolina. The extra point kick by Bobby Moore, so that's the second straight kick he has handled since passing him short miss. It's interesting, Ed. They really didn't have to run another play in terms of trying to go for a score. They were basically in a situation there with a minute to go. They could have taken a knee and run out the time.
But I think at this point, you've got some backups in there. Coach Ray Jackson, they're just running a vanilla offense, I formation. You can't really blame them for at least just running their basic offense.
And one thing they've learned today is that they do have a very capable man who could step in and give Robinson a rest, even if Ray's healthy. Jackson could see more action in future weeks and do the job for them.
Well, and one thing that they've been trying to do is start and finish. When Chukwumato first got here, he said, finish everything. Finish practice, finish every play, finish every game. Well, they've been doing that, but they hadn't started any of those games. Today, they got a very good start, and it ends up in a huge win for them.
We're talking about miscues being the punt problem and the turnovers, but there's also been those penalties. The penalty that extended this drive a minute ago resulted in a touchdown instead of North Carolina getting the ball back down by 11 with about 5 minutes to go.
And last week, that was probably what cost North Carolina State the game. They caused three takeaways, three turnovers by Clemson, and only got a field goal out of those three miscues.
Well, Herbert will kick off. North Carolina State with this win will go to 5-1 overall and 2-1 in the ACC. And North Carolina, after a 3-1 start that had the fans excited here in Chapel Hill, will go to 3-3 and 1-3 in conference. Ball squibbed down the field, bouncing, and finally just smothered by Andre Williams. Flagged out of the 35-yard line. Another flag down to the 15-yard line.
And Sean, this North Carolina State team starting to sniff the top 25, getting some votes.
Well, but I think they'll move in this week without question. They actually gained a lot of respect last week with their first loss. When they're 4-0, people said, oh, they might be the weakest 4-0 team in the country. An illegal block against Carolina. Another personal foul against North Carolina State. But after they lost last week at Clemson, you heard people saying, oh, they're for real. Yeah, they're a very good football team.
It took a loss to get some respect. That's kind of unusual.
Loss.
During the return, we have an illegal block below the waist by the return team. That penalty would take the ball half the distance to the goal. We have a dead ball, personal foul against the white team. That will be 15 yards and a first down.
Well, we still have time to sneak in a few more penalties. Anyway, today's Chevrolet players of the game are Ray Robinson, who rushed for 110 yards for North Carolina State. Julius Peppers with seven tackles and a sack for North Carolina was in that backfield a lot. Chasing Philip Rivers. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university general scholarship fund in the name of these two players.
And unfortunately, Julius Peppers is not out here with his teammates. He suffered a concussion when he went up to try to block a field goal by North Carolina State.
Ronald Curry, who did not have a good day at quarterback, swings it out for Willie Parker. And he's down to the 30. One other note, Corin Robinson just two catches, 41 yards today. So his string of six games in a row with 100 yards receiving will come to an end. He had been tied with Corey Holt until last week. for most consecutive 100-yard receiving games at NC State. He broke the record with 103 last week, but it'll end at six straight games.
But it ends in a game where you see him start to prove that he is not a one-dimensional player. All the things that he does, blocking downfield, running on reverses, punt returns. Corin Robinson is a legitimate big-time player in college football, one of the most exciting guys suiting up today.
Well, the times, they are changing here in the triangle. North Carolina State clearly seems to be a program on the rise in Tuckamato's first year, and troubled times for the Tar Heels. And finally, NC State has a victory in this rivalry. It's first since 1992. Tuckamato returns to his alma mater in his first year. It's the long-awaited win and a great celebration at midfield by the Wolfpack. Once again, the final score, NC State 38, North Carolina 20. Be with us Monday night as the Jacksonville Jaguars face the Tennessee Titans live at 9 on Monday Night Football. ABC is online at abc.com, keyword ABC College Football. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, continuing the tradition of excellence.